peas. Somebody get back! Night.
Hello?
Young Master Malcolm.
Francis, hi.
Hey, man, I wrote you guys a really long letter yesterday. But listen, they only gave me like 3 minutes here, so would you put the special prosecutor on?
Mom, it's Francis!
Hey, Francis, how's school?
Oh, couldn't be better, Mom. My new roommate showed me how to kill mice with a hammer yesterday, so... You know, between that and the general atmosphere of simmering homoeroticism, I think I'm really starting to turn around.
Honey, it's only until summer.
Come on! Push it! Give it up, prom date!
Yeah, listen, I know I shouldn't ask, but would you be able to send me my allowance, like, a couple weeks early? Because I kind of...
Oh, my God, are you smoking?
What?
I can hear you smoking. You're smoking, aren't you?
Mom, I'm not smoking. Jeez.
After seeing the anguish your father and I went through to quit, did any of that register with you? Okay, listen. I'll talk to your dad. Maybe we can send you part of it. Honey, I have to go. I'm late for work.
I'll call you later.
Okay, thanks, Mom. I love you.
Oh, I love you. Somebody get the door!
I'm not getting it. You get it, butt munch.
Shut up.
You shut up.
No, you shut up.
Make me!
Girl, I'll make you right now!
You better not be fighting in there, Reese. Malcolm!
Not my face!
I said you better not be fighting in... Wild Reese! Malcolm! Yes, can I help you?
Oh, my goodness. Hi, hello. I'm Carolyn Miller from Malcolm School. I sent you some letters and left some messages on your answering machine.
Okay, fine. You got me. What do you want?
Well, it's been 3 weeks and you haven't responded. And it's really important. I mean, well, for Malcolm's sake, that the parents be as involved as...
So what? You're here to insult my parenting skills?
No, I'm sure you're a terrific parent. I'm here because I think that there is a tremendous opportunity for Malcolm. Could you, you know, maybe put a top on?
They're just boobs, lady. You see them in the mirror every morning, and I'm sure yours are a lot nicer than mine.
That's actually not the
nature. You know what? I'm going to tell you something else. The reason I didn't respond is because it is a load of crap.
What?
You are not going to stick my Malcolm in some special ed class.
But
what is it with you people? Why do you feel you have to label everybody? Malcolm may be a little strange, and I know, he never shuts up, but he is not disturbed. You know, he's a good boy.
Please! You know what? You don't understand at all. Okay? So if I could just come in for a minute, I could explain everything. Okay?
Oh, my God, Hal.
They saved the TV.
All right!
Yeah! Beautiful work, Lois. Beautiful. You have her exactly where you want her. Totally crazy. Now it's time to take the offensive.
The offensive?
Exactly. She won't... Wait a minute. Did you hear breathing?
What?
Mom?
Malcolm!
Would you hang up the phone, please?
Hi, Mom. Happy anniversary.
Not good. Not good.
What is it? What?
Mom! Phone!
Oh!
Oh, man! Oh, man!
We're gonna die!
That's it. I gotta run away.
Oh, wait! We can get out of this. You have to use that brain of yours. Think!
All I can think about is how hard he's twisting my nipple. Ow! Okay. Think.
I'm not touching you. I was clipping on my tie.
While you were touching me.
Stop it.
Why do we have to do this?
Because we don't have a single picture of us all together. That's ridiculous. We're a family. We should have a family portrait.
Well, Francis isn't here.
Well, I'm not going to cough up $200 to fly him in for one silly picture. Where's Dewey? Dewey, get out of there. That's not your family.
You sure you want autumn leaves as a backdrop?
Yes.
You didn't even look at happy windmills. It's more colorful. Space shuttle.
Next.
Come on, let's go.
I have a coupon here for 1 8x10 and 2 wallet size for $9.99, and that's what I want. I don't want the Golden Moments collection. I don't want the Family and Friends collection. I don't want the Lifetime of Love. I want 1 8x10 and 2 wallet size for $9.99.
Fine.
We have an installment plan, if that would help.
I brought a picture of Francis. He's gonna be in the portrait.
Cool. I'll hold it.
No, I'm gonna hold it.
Let go.
Come on.
I'm gonna hold it.
Let go.
Dewey, pants on, mister.
I'm sorry, but this coupon's expired.
What?
It's expired. What you want will run you $39.50.
Ooh, Lonely Beach. We're kind of the Lonely Beach family, right?
Hell.
But for another $5, you can have the instant memory set. That comes with double exposure silhouettes for the grandparents.
Could you please just do what I'm asking you to?
I'm older.
It was my idea.
That is it. Get up. Get back. Come here. Go there. Okay, we are going to take this picture and it is going to be good. And that means no faces, no tongues, no crossed eyes, no bunny ears. We are going to smile. We are going to look good. It is going to cost us $9.99, and all of this is going to happen by the time I count to three. Stop and you help him.
Yes, there's a Chucky movie on tonight.
Not in this house. You know how your father feels about evil puppet movies?
Please, Mom. It's not even a school night. I can stay up.
You really think you're old enough?
I totally am.
Well, if you really think so.
Oh, Mom, no fair.
What's the matter? Afraid you can't beat your mommy?
She's just a person. She's just a person.
Oh, no! He's finally going to win!
What's he playing for tonight?
Bedtime in a Chucky movie.
Stop screwing around and pin him.
I'm paycheck. I'm gonna say Reese.
Cool. I always wonder where we got it from.
Program. Tickets. Your mother's paycheck.
Now, boys, remember, as far as your mom knows, I have been at work all day.
Okay, go on.
All right.
Well, at least she doesn't know I skipped school all week.
Yeah. Hi, Annie. Hey, you know, I finally found my joke cards. For some reason, they were behind the water heater.
Really?
Hey, how's this? A priest, a rabbi, and Uncle Fred, Aunt Helen, are playing golf with St. Peter.
Hell, please.
Hey, have you seen my pun file? It's in a box marked Laughter Thoughts. Laughter Thoughts?
Do you? No one has to do anything anymore. It's anarchy, baby! That's the word, right?
Mom, I was just wondering if you could wash his shirt for me.
You must be joking.
But you're the only one that knows how to use the washer and dryer without getting shocked. Please?
Well, since you said please. Here you go. All washed.
I don't even like to think about it. It makes me cry.
Hey, hey, hey! What's wrong with you? You know, you're not supposed to skate in the house.
Why? Everyone else in the world gets to.
Wait a minute, somebody stepped on something. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, what a mess! Reese, what did you roll in?
Oh, man.
You have to admit it. It is kind of funny. Yelling so loud you actually throw out your back. Just try to relax. Yeah, got the baby monitor all set up here. And if you need anything, just holler.
but not too loud. And I will get on it.
No! Oh, God!
Sorry?
Oh, God!
Sorry? Lois, why don't you just take the pain medicine the doctor gave you?
Because they make me loopy. I will not have this house come crashing down around me because I'm hopped up on goofballs.
Mom, I'm really sorry. Are you okay?
Oh, Reese, come to Mama. Closer, sweetheart. Are you happy you crippled your mother?
It's her. Or maybe you could, I don't know, shut up about your mom for half a second. No one's that bad.
Hey, I've been sugarcoating it for you because you're enfeebled.
Frances!
You can just see for yourself.
Hi, honey. You look terrible.
You think that's going to appease your guilt?
What guilt? Boy, it's stuffy in here. That can't be good for you. You look pasty. Have you had a bowel movement? When is the last time you moved your bowels?
Mom?
Hello.
Who are you?
Edwin Spangler. I am Commandant of Marlin Academy.
Good for you. Where's your eye?
Pardon?
Do your ears work? Do you have some business with my son? He needs to rest.
Well, I stopped by to pick up your boy's homework.
Homework? You're not giving him homework. My son nearly lost his life. Something that never would have happened if you'd taken proper care of him in the first place.
Well, I assure you, ma'am, had it not been for Francis's long history of crying wolf.
Crying wolf? You listen to me, you idiot. My child is sick. He does not need you marching in here, puffing up your little chest and making his life more miserable than it already is. Why don't you just go play Army Man somewhere else?
He's gonna go.
God, she is magnificent.
Not.
I know, I'm just rubbing it in.
Rubbing it in.
Your mom is great.
This isn't my mom. It's an act. It's some kind of freaky mind game she's playing with me. Any second now, her face is going to split open. She's going to reveal herself for the evil banshee she really is.
Man, I don't know why she puts up with you.
Anyone for doubles?
Nope.
All right, then.
Oh, hi, honey. Where you been?
I want you to leave.
What?
I want you to leave. You made your phony point. You made me look like an idiot. Mission accomplished.
Okay. You know what? I have had it with you, mister. You have done nothing but bitch and moan since I got here, and I've been nothing but pleasant.
Exactly.
Oh, what? You complain when I'm pleasant, and you complain when I'm not pleasant? There's no winning with you. Why don't you just tell me exactly how you want me to behave every second of the day, and we'll see if that satisfies you.
This isn't fair. You're taking my pain and you're twisting it into your guilt trip.
Fine. Why don't I just leave then?
Fine.
Fine.
Boys!
Reese, I've done some soul searching in the last few minutes. I hereby offer my complete and full apology. It was very wrong of me. I'm truly sorry for my childish and inappropriate behavior. And I'd like to think that the terrible guilt of feeling is punishment enough for...
Hey, there's no cutting in line. Oh, it's you again.
Reese, I'm so sorry. I really, really mean it.
Do you think we're wealthy?
What?
Do you think we're wealthy? Wealthy people drive fancy cars. They buy fresh pasta. Do we do any of those things? No!
Wealthy people can afford to have their vacations ruined. No big deal. They just pick up and they go again.
Your father and I worked so hard. We worked so long. What is wrong with you two? Are you Aborigines? Every time I turn around, I hear someone screaming and fighting, and I pray to God it's someone else's kids, but it's not. It's always you. Sane children would appreciate this.
And you have to keep nattering at each other like a couple of rabid monkeys. It is not enough that you do this every day. You have to make me suffer too.
So help me. You dare.
Arms and legs crossed at all times.
That is the bravest thing I've ever seen you do.
Yeah.
You're gonna die.
I know. So do you think she's okay?
be the guy in the silver Toyota.
Why can't you just open one lane?
Lady, we have to wait for the crane to get here before we can even think of opening this road to traffic.
Yeah, but if you just moved a couple of those police cars, there'd be enough room to just pass on the shoulder. I mean, this is just plain stupid.
Ma'am, don't call a police officer stupid.
But that's a law now? Look, they're just standing around. Yeah, 500 cars full of people who actually have someplace to go, and they're just standing there talking. What is there to discuss? Hey! Let me clear something up for you! This is a car wreck! You're a road crew! Do your job!
Well,
are you even listening to me?
That could have been me.
Yeah, well, hell, it could have been all of us.
Nope. No, that car was sliced right through the driver's seat. You and the boys would have walked away without a scratch.
Think about it, Lois. I stopped to tie my shoe in the parking lot. If I hadn't done that, we would have been on the road 20 seconds sooner. I would have been 200 yards ahead of where I was. And then I would have been the silver Toyota.
And if you hadn't rented body heat, we never would have had Dewey. It's all an intricate tapestry, Hal.
Ma'am?
Yes. Did you ask your supervisor?
Yes, and this phone is for emergency roadside assistance only, ma'am. I can't connect you to a private line.
Look, I have got to get through to my babysitter. Look, just let me talk to the supervisor.
One moment, ma'am.
Hello, this is the supervisor.
No, it isn't. You're just disguising your voice.
No, I'm not. I'm really the supervisor.
You can't do this!
Ma'am, I'm about to be replaced by a machine. I can do whatever I damn well please.
Protect anyway. Do you see anything on here worth protecting?
What are we doing up here?
Just enjoying the sights. And check out that crazy lady. So tell me.
Okay, let me get this straight. We have been waiting all afternoon for a crane, and now the crane is here.
That's right.
And the man who works the crane, he's here too.
That's right.
Then why is nothing happening?
Look, we can't touch anything until the investigators sign off on the accident report.
Okay, but they must have been done hours ago. Where are they?
That's a whole nother department. It's really not my job to know.
Start the crane.
You can't tell me what to do.
Try the green one.
Come on out of there, ma'am.
You order them to move this thing.
Let's just get you out of the crane, and then we'll have a little talk.
Don't you dare patronize me.
Okay, you don't want to be patronized? I'll be blunt. You're a control freak. I see them all the time. But guess what? This is a traffic jam. It is out of your control.
Yeah, but
you can't boss it around. You can't yell at it and expect it to listen.
It will
end when it ends. You just have to live with it. There's absolutely nothing you can do about it.
Whose damn dog is this? I said, whose damn dog is this? It's trapped inside, all the windows are rolled up. It's like 90 degrees out here. Okay. If it's nobody's damn dog, then I guess nobody's gonna mind if I just do this. Oh, don't be scared, little doggy. Oh, no, everything's gonna be a...
Can I help you?
Give me your money.
Oh, for crying out loud again?
Just shut up and hand it over.
Okay, just relax, cowboy. We have a way of doing this and nobody gets hurt. I give you every bit of money in this drawer and you and your friend just leave, okay?
Okay.
See? Nobody gets hurt. Nobody gets caught. Everybody happy, okay?
Lois! I think Cheryl A. flipped me off behind my back.
Greg, I'm with some customers. Here you go. Bye now.
Did you enjoy your Lucky 8 shopping experience, gentlemen?
Craig, they're in a hurry.
This won't take a second. Hi, I'm Craig, I'm the assistant manager. I can assure you if there's one thing we value here at Lucky 8, it is customer satisfaction.
We're satisfied.
But you don't sound like it. Now, please don't feel like you're going to hurt my feelings because I'm learning here. Now, I'm sure there's something I could do to make this a better experience for you.
Yeah. How about you walk me to every other register in this place and give me every cent you've got?
That's a gun!
Craig, calm down. Just everybody calm down. I've been through this 5 times. We just give them money from all the other registers and they'll leave.
What about the safe?
Safe?
Tea. Safe tea of the customers.
I'll lock the doors, you start rounding up the customers.
What are you, nuts? We gotta get out of here.
Come on, man. I'm tired of doing these dinky little holdups. Have you ever wanted to do something more important with your life?
What do you mean, like go back to school?
No, man. Like break it into a safe. Do you want to work at Orange Julius forever?
All right! Everybody over to Sundries! Don't you worry, Lois. Everything is going to be fine. Just fine and dandy. Yeah, keep waving that thing around, buddy boy. You got a big surprise coming.
Craig, that button has been disconnected for over a year.
What? Why?
Because you kept hitting the damn thing.
In an emergency, yes, that's what it's for.
Oh, like an emergency when you saw a bee? Or when you saw the big fly that looked like a bee? How about when you thought you saw a ghost?
I'm not saying it was or it wasn't, but you can't tell me what we saw was normal.
All right, you two, let's move it.
He likes waving that around too much. This is gonna end in body bags.
No, Craig, it isn't.
Lois, before we die, I have to tell you something. It's about how I feel.
Craig, no.
But Lois...
Craig, no! This will all be over soon!
Live, live, die. Live, 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 die.
Hey! What happened to the judicial system presided over by a tribunal of wise elders?
I am lined up and shot.
Huh. You know, son, maybe you've been spending too much...
Silence!
Seize him!
All right, son. I think it's time you goose-step off to bed.
Dad! You're embarrassing me in front of my men!
Hal! Why is this still here?
Reese's report card. It is much better than last time.
Really?
Yeah. This time he used the exact same brand of pen as the teacher to change his grade.
Look at that. He gave himself a C in math and 7 A+.
Yeah, it's subtle. Nice attention to detail. He's really learning. 2 months grounded?
3 months. Scrubbing toilets. No, Hal. No borrowing. We have a clean slate with these people. We're going to behave. I want to have one person on this earth who can pick up the mail.
Your mother's right. Doesn't hurt to have allies on the block. Especially allies with the pool. We just gotta make sure we get to them before the Reeds can poison them against us. Or the McCartys. Or the Whitfords. We definitely need to get to them before the Whitfords.
I see Mrs. Schneider circling.
Go, 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 go.
You wanna see something funny? Hey, quit staring at my mom's chest.
What? I'm not. Malcolm, knock it off.
But I wasn't.
Ah, get away from me! Ah, get away from me!
Your daughter is biting my son. Oh, look, they're just playing.
Oh, it hurts! It hurts! Mommy! Oh. Oh. Oh.
Now, honey, if you want to breathe, you're going to have to open your mouth and let go of my son.
What are you doing?
It's just a little trick I picked up.
How dare you touch my daughter?
She was gnawing on my son. If you're not going to control her.
Are you questioning my parenting?
I don't know. I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, nice. This from a woman raising a pervert.
Where is he supposed to look? You got him laid out like a couple of eggs on a plate.
I wasn't. Emily, Josh, I don't want you playing with these awful children anymore.
Hey, my...
Well, they may be awful, but they're a hell of a lot better than your two brats.
Your mom said to stay away from us!
Damn it! Damn it! Hector, not over there! Are you deaf or stupid or both? Could you please try to be a little less useless? Where is the sun? Do you see the sun? I told you to dig the holes over there. El Sol? God, you people drive me nuts with your laziness. What is the matter with you?
Excuse me?
You can't talk to him like that. He's a human being. You talk to him like he's some kind of animal. I will deal with the help the way I want to. He is not the help. He's not a servant or a slave. He's a professional. He's a person with a skill you do not have, which is why you hired him. Now, for God's sake, just pick it up! Oh, my God! What are you doing? These are our hedges! This is the property line! The property line! The property line! You can't cross the property line! I can see you. Don't think you can hide from me. Why don't you come out here and apologize to me like an adult? Woo! Oh, that's real mature. I don't think you can get rid of me so easy. Fine. That's the way you want it to be? You'll get these back when you fix my hedges! Smoking again?
No, I am cleaning. Do you smell smoke?
No, but I...
No, Lois, if I wanted to smoke a cigar, I wouldn't be sneaking around like a scared little schoolboy. I would do it out in the open like a man.
That was our third shop vac. That is our last shop vac. I don't want to hear any excuses. You will sit down every night and work until those grades are up.
Why do I have to tutor him?
Because God gave you a giant brain. Blame him.
Reese screws up and I get punished for it? Where's the logic in that?
Malcolm, I have zero tolerance on this one.
Finally, Mom found the courage to speak her mind.
Why aren't you fixing that roof?
It's 40 degrees out there. I'll freeze. And it's gonna rain.
That's why you have to fix the roof!
Well, maybe if you didn't buy such crappy shingles, it wouldn't leak all the time.
Francis, as long as you are in this house, you will do as I say.
You know what, Mom? No. I'm too old to be bullied by you. Our whole lives, you have done nothing but dictate what you wanted. You're the boss of the world, and we're all sick of it. This may be your roof, but we live here too. We are human beings with rights, and I'm hereby putting an end to your reign of terror.
You should have seen the look on her face. It was totally worth it.
Sounds like you've had it rough.
Oh, man, you have no idea.
I'm sorry. No one wanted it to turn out this way. I feel like I let Reese down.
Just keep moving, Tony.
So where does this leave us? I think it's best if we make the switch as soon as possible. We need to look at this as an opportunity.
Big opportunity being in the dumb class.
Reese, this isn't what I wanted, but you haven't left us any choice.
Mom, don't do this. It's not Reese's fault. He didn't deserve an F on that test.
Malcolm, we've already had this discussion.
I saw the test. He did a good job. He deserved a B. This guy is totally out to get him.
Malcolm.
Look, I'm sorry you feel that way, but you can't blame me for Reese's shortcomings.
Mom, this is the test. Take a look at this question. What was the cause of the Great Depression? He put down Black Thursday. That's a correct answer.
No, that's only a partial answer. To get full credit, he should have included the vast overproduction in the U.S., protectionism in the foreign markets.
Overexpansion of credit and stock market speculation?
Yes, that would have been a complete answer.
Ha! You didn't read the answer because that's exactly what I wrote.
I wrote?
The royal I, as in Reese. Because I think we can all identify with what he's going through.
You took that test, didn't you? You cheated! You let him cheat for you? You gave something he wrote an F? You are out to get him! Oh, I can't wait to see you expelled or disbarred or whatever it is they do to creepy little men who abuse their power.
There is no need for name-calling. I suggest we just leave things as they are.
Oh, I don't think so.
Here's the situation. If you notify the school, then the school will find out Malcolm cheated. He'll be expelled.
Don't you threaten me.
This isn't a threat. I just don't think you'd throw away the son who achieves for, well, Reese.
You don't think I'd sacrifice this one? Let me explain something to you. I would sell Malcolm down the river in a heartbeat to save Reese.
What?
Malcolm's gonna be fine no matter what happens. Maybe he'll have to go to junior college or start off blue collar, but he'll work his way up to management eventually. Reese is the one who needs saving.
I don't believe you. No mother could ever be that callous to her own son.
Mom, please let me come home. I'm cold and I'm hungry. Please, I'll fix the roof. I'll paint the house. I'll do anything, Mom, please. Just let me live indoors, Mom. Please, I don't want to be warm again. Mom, please.
Maybe we can work something out.
You see, Malcolm, isn't it great when you don't have to worry about the gutters? You can just bowl and have fun.
I wish I could be alone somewhere.
Me too. Wait, I still have to tell you that joke. Would you like to take a walk on the beach? Feel the salt? You know what? That's not a good joke.
Mom, I don't want to do this.
Malcolm, I didn't raise you to stop trying when something is hard. You can do this. You just concentrate on those pins. You throw the ball. You are not giving up until you bowl a strike.
Your mother's right, Connie.
My name's not Connie. Okay, Mom, you want to see a strike?
Malcolm, what are you doing?
Look at me. I'm the world's greatest bowler. I care so much about bowling. Bowling is so important.
Malcolm, come back here.
You want a strike? I'll give you a strike. Here's your damn strike. Way to go, Connie. Listen, maybe you should be... Connie. Oh, man, that was classic. Okay, let's go make out.
I don't think so.
Okay, I think bowling's over. Get your jackets. I'm taking everyone home. Turn in the shoes. I'll meet you out front. Out loud. Well, let's get you cleaned up. Don't forget your ears, Dewey.
Okay.
This ear? If you had just shut up and left me alone, it'd be fixed by now.
You two disgust me.
All right, this should do it.
Let me do it.
I'm doing it.
I told you I could fix it. Way to go, jackass. So get out of my way.
Get off.
No.
You kids, you're not allowed to have a motorcycle.
What are you doing?
That's ours.
You paid for it with their own money.
Oh, well, that was pretty stupid of you, wasn't it? There's no way you're having a motorcycle.
But, Mom, it's not a motorcycle. It's just a little mini bike.
It's a motorcycle.
It's not a motorcycle. It's 2 feet high. It was made specifically for kids.
Two wheels, motor, motorcycle.
Mom's just doing this because she can't stand that we were actually working together.
I know. Fixing that bike up was the best time we ever had.
I never wanted it to end.
Yeah. We were a perfect team.
We still are. The three of us, we're going to work together and find a way to beat her.
She's going down.
Hey, wait a minute.
Boys! I need some help! Oh. What's this?
Looks like a picture of you on a horse. What were you about, Dewey's age?
What are you doing with this?
This looks awfully dangerous. Look at that. No padding, no helmet. Did you ever fall?
What does this have to do with...
We're asking the questions.
So, according to your logic, a 2-foot fall from a mini bike is more dangerous than a 6-foot fall from a galloping horse.
That was a long time ago.
Before gravity?
I don't have time for this right now. I have to get ready. I have to go to work.
Did you see that? We totally rattled her. Mom, for God's sake, they just came over to say hi.
I took the key to the girls' locker room.
Please don't tell our mothers.
I'm so ashamed.
What?
You did that just to humiliate me.
Is that what you think?
Yes. It was completely unjustified. And I want you to know, I am never going to forget this.
Well, good. It'll be the first time in 10 years the punishment's actually stuck.
What do you mean you quit?
I quit this stupid system. The only reason I'm being punished like this is because I agreed to be punished like this. And I'm not going to agree anymore. This isn't parenting. This is just sadism.
Oh, you think I enjoy this?
Yes, I do. And I am way too old for this. We are gonna find some other way of dealing with each other. We are gonna change the rules. What are you planning to do? Take away my TV when I'm married? Give me a timeout when I'm 30? What? Am I supposed to be scared? What are you gonna do, spank me?
Okay.
Mom, what are you doing? Mom, cut it out. I don't know what you think you're doing. How did she get so strong?
When I can't do this, we'll change the rules.
I would just like to get one thing clear. When we go home, you fellas are still gonna be a presence in the community, right?
If I wasn't in uniform, I'd take a swing at you myself.
Fair enough.
Are you telling me that I can't discipline my own child?
Lady, we got a lot of angry people in there. I think it's best you stay out here with the other troublemakers.
They'd like us to stay inside the box.
No!
Just let go! It's gonna be dark soon.
I can't.
Yes, you can. Just open your fingers.
But I'll fall.
That's the point, Dewey. Just... don't think. Just do it. Just let go.
No.
Oh, for crying out loud. You let go of that rope and you come in for dinner. Oh, come on, honey.
No. Ow.
Come on, honey. I'm making French fries.
Ow.
Your favorite ice cream. You know you love ice cream.
Sex offender. A registered sex offender. And for what? For some trampy girl? For...
Mom, please. I feel terrible. I completely understand what I did. I sold out my own father for a girl. It's like the worst thing I've ever done. We both agree I'm a terrible person.
For some girl you- day. That's the gratitude you showed your father.
Hey, maybe I'm the good one after all. Here, Mom, for your throat. I put a little honey in it.
That man gets one vacation a year, and this is how you start it. You go and make it right.
Don't worry, I just let the air out. We can talk while I put on your spare. Look, I'm sorry I had to resort to this, but you have to give me 5 minutes so we can talk. Talk over the music. You can't drive on a flat.
Leaving. He just wants to talk to you. Just hear him out. Lois, this has got to stop. He's going very far away, and you're not going to see him for a very long time. Honey, there are moments in life that you just don't get back, and I know you. If you do not deal with this now, it will haunt you forever. Fine. I've lost a son, but gained a baby. I tried.
I know.
Are you sure this is what you want?
Well, it better be.
Francis? Listening.
This is what you get. This is what you get for the way you treated me. I'm going to Alaska, and you're going to be left without a son. And the horrible way you treated me is now a matter of public record.
I treated you? We made sacrifice after sacrifice for you, and you've caused us nothing but pain.
You want pain? I got your scars, baby. 3.5 years in that horrible school.
We went without for that school.
Oh, maybe I should thank you. Thank you, Mother, for making my life a living hell!
Living hell? You've been nothing but a problem since the day you were
born!
Your
problems are over, lady, because I'm out of here!
Getting Fred fell in the bush, and then he just started hitting him and hitting him and hitting him. It was way cool.
Jimmy Perkins is crazy.
It's like I've always told you boys, crazy beats big every time. So how was your day, dear?
Caller. Mom said he ran away.
Get out of there, Dewey. Tracy really should have invited us. This is what people get for being rude. Okay, we'll hide these in the closet tonight. When we get out, we'll cover up the hole, and by the time Mom's home, we'll be in bed sleeping like babies.
Boys! Fireworks! Fireworks! Oh!
How did she?
I don't know. Boys are in so much trouble! I can't leave you alone for a second! I guess next time I go out, I'll have to chain you to the floor! We tell you to behave and you don't even pretend to listen! You might as well cut up your ears and throw them in the trash for as little as you use them! You are grounded for the next month!
Get down on the ground with your hands behind your head!
And while you're being punished, I hope your friends are doing all sorts of fun stuff! Because you won't be doing any of it! You are going to...
Honey? We're back.
Hey, guys. Why don't you wash up? Dinner's ready. I made your favorite. Meatloaf and mashed potatoes.
Okay.
Great.
Why isn't she mad?
What happened?
All of her stuff's gone.
That's right. I gave it all to charity. You now have 2 changes of clothes, one for school and one for home. Something wrong?
No, we're fine. This is crazy.
I have enough in my mind without worrying about you boys and your shenanigans.
But, Mom...
You and your brother are not to leave this room. I don't want to see you. I don't want to hear you. I don't want to so much as sense your presence. For crying out loud, Reese, there's a mirror right there! Believe me, I am going to watch that door like a hawk.
Mom, Dad, we have something to say.
We know why you've been crying so much lately. You don't have to protect us from this. We think getting a divorce is a great idea.
What?
You don't have to stay together for us. We've known for years your marriage was a sham.
I mean, clearly your relationship isn't working. Mom, you need someone who's going to control you better, and Dad needs someone younger.
You both deserve some happiness. In fact, I think we all do.
Amen to that.
So I guess we should be going to a motel with Dad or something?
Our bags are packed. And don't worry, Mom, you'll still be part of our lives. We'll see you every other weekend, and feel free to call us anytime. Mom, how nice to see you home.
I have had it!
What are you doing?
I am taking everything. Every present, every decoration, every treat. I am locking it in the garage. Every single Christmas, you scream or burn or break or destroy, and I am putting a stop to it!
She's stealing Christmas!
Mom, you can't do this.
Yeah, this is the last year Dewey will believe in Santa Claus.
What?
If you boys behave until Christmas morning, there will be a Christmas morning. Otherwise, these are going back to the store, and Christmas will be canceled.
You want to cancel Christmas? You're bluffing.
You canceled Christmas?
I'm not canceling Christmas. I'm holding it hostage. I know, it seems harsh, but nothing else has ever worked. Every year, we yell, we threaten, we bargain, we beg. Maybe this time, they'll behave. We're in this together. I'm playing the unity card.
But
Unity card, Hal!
But I love Christmas.
I know you do, dear.
Wait, isn't there anything that trumps the unity card?
Hell.
Doofus?
Yes. I don't know what I was thinking, taking presents away from children. What kind of a sick person does that? Look, I just want to get everything out of the garage, set it up in the house, and have a nice Christmas. You know what? Why don't we wake up the boys and have Christmas tonight? I can't wait to see the look on their sweet little faces. Well, Hal, that was smart of you to wake up the boys so they could help us carry in the presents.
Yes. Welcome. Come on. Hurry up, boys.
Sure.
Yeah.
Looks like Reese got a D in English. And Dewey seems to be fighting again.
Fighting?
Oh, Malcolm, tell your teacher I'd love to chaperone the class overnight. We can share a tent.
Dewey, how come you're not playing with your toy? What are you smiling about? Where did you get this?
Cheek to cheek is heaven.
Have a seat. In a minute, you and Mrs. Johnson do the forbidden dance. You think that's the only copy? What do you take me for? Enjoy your assembly tomorrow.
So I'm going to the ball game with Abe this weekend. I had one ticket, invited me.
That's great, dear. I'm glad. What's this?
Thank you.
was trying to get rid of me. Hal, turn this off. Hal?
Oh, my God, I can't believe how beautifully you dance.
Hal, you are such a fool.
Our marriage.
What? I didn't tell him. Listen, lady, you gotta stop this. I don't have time for my own family's problems without listening to you two nutcases. So why don't you just... I don't think you understood me.
I'm in shock.
Well, you should be. I've been planning this for months.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, happy birthday, honey.
Well, hold on. I got another surprise for you.
Oh.
Everybody, this is Piyama. She's my wife. We're married.
Hi.
I was gonna tell you over the phone, and then I thought, why not bring her down here and surprise you in person?
What do you mean you're married?
Piyama and I are husband and wife. We got married last week.
Last week?
Francis, who is this woman?
She's my wife. Her name is Piyama.
Hello.
Well, come on. Isn't anyone going to congratulate us?
What?
For getting married? That's what families do?
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Well, come on, Mom. You can at least try and be happy for me.
I'm sorry, Francis. This is a hell of a thing to dump in my lap on your father's birthday.
Yeah, it's all about you, Mom. Excuse me for thinking that my family would be excited to meet my wife. I can't believe you guys.
Come on, Francis. It's not their fault. What'd you expect? You could have at least called ahead of time.
Boys, go to your room.
What? What do you mean we're on your side?
I said go!
long have you known each other? You never mentioned her.
Well, I only met her a month ago. Today. Happy anniversary. Plus, we had the whole bus ride down.
A month? I misjudged you. You know, come to think of it, that's the longest you've ever stuck with anything in your life. Congratulations. You outlasted his paper route.
Lady, you don't want to stick your hand in my face.
Hey, everybody, let's just calm down.
We are calm. It's Mom who's flipping out.
Oh, Francis, I haven't even started to flip out.
Why can't you just be happy for us?
Okay, boys, get your things. We're going home.
No, we're not going back there.
Well, you can't stay in this hotel room forever. What are you going to do? Live under a bridge and steal food out of dumpsters?
I don't know, but we're not going home. We've had it with the way you treat us, and we've had it with all the yelling. You are a terrible influence on us. All you ever do is scream.
And order us around.
There's something wrong with this family. Family should have some way of communicating besides yelling.
Okay, everybody, calm down. I understand what you're saying. I am not going to yell. I am not going to scream. We are capable of talking about this without raising our voices. Now, boys, I want you to understand, I'm sorry about what happened. But you have to understand, I get a little emotional when I learn that my oldest son was acting like an idiot and throwing his life away. Now, that doesn't mean...
Stop talking about him like that! Francis is my heart!
Okay, we're even. Everyone's fine and there's no need for escalation. Isn't it beautiful when things work out?
Yeah, I'd say this has gone pretty well. I mean, considering we got off to a rocky start, we couldn't have asked for a better ending.
Get your wife out of my sight. She called you my wife. That's progress.
For those of you who don't think that Marty did steal the motorcycle...
Look, if it'll get us out of here earlier, I don't mind changing my vote.
What?
I don't feel that strongly either way.
Yeah, me too. Which side was winning again?
This is not a question of winning. And I don't think we should be voting whichever way gets us out of here the fastest.
Well, we have to have some basis for deciding.
There was a trial. And evidence. And laws.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's just vote one more time before we, you know, get into all that detail. We might just get lucky. Do the five people who voted not guilty want to change their votes?
Yeah, whatever.
There you go. It's unanimous.
Wait! What do you think you're doing? You can't send a 17-year-old kid to jail just because you want to go home early. For God's sake, we took an oath!
Lady, did you vote guilty?
Yes, because...
Then there's no problem. We're all just agreeing with you. Let's go.
Fine. Then I vote not guilty.
Clock. Now, we've got the attendant at the gas station who puts Marty's whereabouts there between 4 and 4:30, and as we all remember from the testimony...
Can we vote again?
What's the use? We've been through this 5 times. We vote guilty, she votes not guilty. We vote not guilty, she votes guilty.
Yeah. So you go first this time.
All right. I abstain.
What is it that you want, lady?
I want you to do your job. I want you to weigh the facts of this case and make a reasoned decision. You have got the sworn testimony of the arresting police officer, in which he clearly states...
Yeah, if you believe what he says.
Okay, that's fair enough. It is a question of credibility. On one hand, you have a 17-year-old high school dropout with a history of reckless behavior. And on the other, you have a 20-year veteran of the police force.
Well, you sure as hell can't trust the cops. They're always coming up with ways to get you.
That's right. My neighbor's a cop, and he's got a 30-foot boat in his front yard. Now, how can he afford a 30-foot boat on a policeman's salary?
Cops are always getting away with stuff like that.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
You can start now. I'll tell you, when I was a kid...
Stop! This is not about how you feel about cops. This is not about who you like and who you hate. This is about what you believe happened based on the facts of the trial. Did Marty or did Marty not, in fact, steal the motorcycle?
Wait, I thought Marty was the cop.
Yeah. That's what I thought.
Fine. Let's go through this again.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Is it okay to hate you?
Absolutely. Gassing up the motorcycle a half an hour after the owner said it went missing.
But doesn't that gas station close at 5 o'clock?
Not on Fridays. She pointed that out in the transcript. I think we're ready for another vote. Lois?
Go ahead.
By a show of hands, who thinks the defendant is guilty? Great. Let's go tell the judge.
Wait! I
don't think Marty is guilty.
What?
I went through all these papers, and it says the kid sings in a church choir. I just don't feel a church-going boy would do something like this.
That is not fact. That's bias. You are basing a decision on feelings that have nothing to do with facts. Facts are things. Like witnesses seeing Marty steal a bike. Like Marty being apprehended while he was driving the stolen bike. Like Marty pulling tons of stupid stunts just like this one. Those are the facts.
I just don't want to send that poor boy to jail.
Oh, believe me, jail is going to do him a lot more good than 3 years of military school ever did.
Military school?
I didn't read anything about military school.
I didn't see anything
about military school. Yeah. I know I saw that somewhere.
I don't think so. Didn't he drop out of vocational school?
That's right. After he transferred from the private school where he got caught messing around with the teacher's aide.
You don't understand. I know for a fact that Francis went...
Who?
Oh, my God. I think I have to excuse myself from this jury.
All in favor?
I serve on another jury. I know. I messed up this time, but the next time I will do it right.
I'm not responsible for scheduling that.
I'm sure you have connections. Please, I just need another chance.
Seems there was some kind of mistrial earlier. Now everything's backed up. You're gonna have to wait.
I'll do the best I can, if you promise to stop bothering me right now.
Deal! I gotta go. My husband's probably gone crazy without me. My God, what did you do to your pants?
What?
Oh, for crying out loud, how did you get a stain there already?
Mom, come on.
It wasn't there this morning.
Mom, stop. It's no big deal.
No big deal? You begged me for these pants. You almost started crying in the store when I wasn't going to buy them for you. And now, look what you did to them.
That looks like that's coming from the inside.
Mom, leave me alone. You're embarrassing me.
Oh, I am not embarrassing you.
Would you be embarrassed by this? No, see? Come on. See if we can find some club soda and get that out.
What? What? Okay, I ate the cupcakes you baked for Dewey's class last night. And I took Dad's license to make a fake ID. And I can't return your necklace because I already sold it.
I was just gonna say your shirt didn't go with your pants.
How?
You!
And what do you think, Scott?
Well, basically the points that he's got over here are valid, but I think my percentage rates here in the annual earnings
at a historical low. That's correct.
Yes, it just doesn't add up.
Well, I think we can all agree on that. We've lost about 14 years of higher
Give Reese a slice from the fuzzy side, and I didn't see a thing.
Why do you have to take your pillow to your sister's?
Well, hell, I don't know how long I'm going to be there. I want to be comfortable.
Well, what am I supposed to sniff while you're gone?
Mom's baby doctor is making her move to her sister's house for a while. Dad's starting to get used to it. At least now he goes out to the garage to cry.
Aha! No coaster! Look at that ring! That is why I have to move out of this house.
Mom.
Every time you boys thoughtlessly mar the furniture by refusing to use coasters, what are you doing?
Killing the baby.
Killing the baby. Every time you run through the house, every time you destroy furniture, every time you fight with each other, you are killing the baby.
Lois, the doctor just said you should avoid stress.
Which is just medical jargon for the simple fact that every time you boys misbehave, you might as well be taking a knife and putting it in that baby's tiny little heart.
Will you stop saying that?
I just hope you boys have the character to channel the horrible guilt you should be feeling into better behavior while I'm gone. With that girl, weren't you?
No, I was at the library studying.
You were supposed to pick your brother up at school.
There were rocks. There was a beehive. But where were you?
You are not allowed to see that girl.
Her name is Nikki, and I'm not seeing her.
Every time you lie to me, it is like you are digging a tiny little grave.
I am not lying to you. Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. You know, Mom, you're looking lovely today. People don't appreciate how lovely you can be in the right light. I'm always telling kids at school that I'm the loveliest mother.
I'll put on the coffee.
It's Hanson. Make decaf.
All my old stuff. Everything in that garage represents a precious childhood memory. It's a bunch of old magazines, a broken yo-yo, and a Rubik's Cube painted all one color.
Will you try and solve that thing?
I'm not going to argue with you. You have 10 seconds to come up with a good reason to keep all that junk, or I'm getting rid of it. See, this is why you are a terrible mother, because everything has to be a competition with you.
Oh, it does not.
I'm hanging up.
I'm hanging up first.
No, I'm hanging.
As soon as the swelling in my ankles goes down, I'm going to get right back to work with you boys.
Thank you, honey.
No matter what it does to the baby.
Go! Reese, don't, you stupid jackass. You don't even know what you're doing.
That is enough out of you. Are you really so insecure that you can't stand anyone else getting any attention? Your brother has worked so hard to make this yard sale a success, he doesn't need you undermining him at every turn.
Mom, you have to listen to me. We have a Nortair 680B. It's a type of computer that was built in 1976. There's only a few in existence, and Craig is going to give us $1,300 for it.
$1,300? Oh, my God! What are you doing?
I have a lot of things to sell, and I don't have time to argue with this bozo. I've got a jet ski on hold, and the place closes at 6.
What are you talking about?
I'm buying a jet ski with my yard sale money.
That money isn't yours. He's going to rebuild our bedroom wall.
But you said I was in charge. That means I get the money.
No, it doesn't.
Then why the hell would I want to be in charge?
Reese, this is helping you become a better person by building your self-esteem, which you are obviously going to need if you are stupid enough to throw away $1,300 that this family desperately needs. Oh, for God's sake, what was that? Wherever you are, whatever you've done, don't think I won't find you.
There has to be some way to get rid of her.
Well, we know she doesn't burn.
Let's just face it, we're stuck with her. You can't give up. You can totally do this.
I'm sorry, I just don't know what to do. She's too powerful.
Every monster has its weakness. Frankenstein has fire. Dracula the cross. There has to be something that Grandma's afraid of.
So, what would you like me to do for you?
Well, it's kind of hard to say, Abe. It has to do with my mother.
Oh, I know about mothers. Every time mine comes over to Sunday dinner, she always brings that pecan pie with real whipped cream. And she knows that's my one weakness.
Our grandma's kind of like that, except she's a wrinkled sack of hatred kept alive only by the will to destroy.
We just want her out of the house, and she refuses to leave. And I had this idea. You see, she's a horrible bigot. I mean, she's terrified of black people.
Oh. What do you want me to... Huh. Oh, I see. Because I'm... Do you want me to... Well, I suppose I... Really?
I do it, but I'm not dark enough. I just annoy her.
You're coming over. I know, this is a little weird.
Actually, I'm kind of excited. This is kind of like when I did Spoon River Anthology in college.
Do we have to hear that story again?
We sold out both shows.
Four pillows on one bed. This is why you can't feed your children.
Oh, hi, Mom. I'd like you to meet some of our friends. This is Brian, and this is Abe.
Nice to meet you, ma'am. If you'll excuse me, I need to use your toilet.
I've been telling Abe all about you.
Welcome to the hood. Yo, yo. Getting all jiggly with it. Representing... can't touch this.
Abe. Huh? Joe.
Hello?
Everybody decent? I used my spare key to get in. I hope you don't mind.
That's why you have it. So you can come over anytime you want. Mom, these are our neighbors. Steve lives next door. Malik is on the other side. And Trey lives across the street.
Why, Lois, you make it sound like you're surrounded.
Allow me.
Well, hello.
And who is this fine lady? So what you doing later on? Because I like that wagon you drag.
Finally, Mama's going to have some pictures of her beautiful baby to show all her friends at work.
Proposal for you. Now, before you start poking holes in it, I'd like you to hear me out. All I want is no more school and no more big boy clothes. I'd like to be bathed and rocked before I go to sleep and have all my food mashed up. In return, I'll be adorable and...
Are you wearing a diaper?
I want you to know my level of commitment.
Oh my God!
Mom, can I talk to you?
No, honey, please, don't talk to me about this. No matter what I say, I'm going to be blamed. This is for you to work out with that woman.
Piyama.
I know her name.
Can you just listen to me for a second? If Piyama and I ever were to get a divorce...
Francis, don't even talk like that. I mean it. You really shouldn't. What were you going to say?
If we ever were to split up, could I stay here for a while?
God, Francis, I didn't even think of such a thing. But yes, if such a terrible thing were to happen, of course, we'd be here for you.
Thanks, Mom. I mean, it was a stupid fight, I guess, but it was emblematic of everything that was bad with the relationship. I mean, there were principles.
Principles are important.
I know. I mean, so what if I'd had a couple beers? How's it look in front of the guys if the woman's driving?
What?
She didn't care about my feelings at all.
What?
What?
Of all the idiotic, asinine things you have ever said, Francis, this has got to be one of the worst.
I thought you were on my side.
You don't have a side? Now, you are going to go and apologize to that woman. You are going to tell her that you are wrong and she is absolutely blameless.
You really...
Go!
Okay.
Yes, he isn't. Why haven't you talked to her yet?
She won't let me. Every time I go near her, she walks out of the room.
Piyama, I know that you and I have had our differences.
Oh, you mean the cold and comfortable silences broken by the occasional veiled insult?
I'm not sure I would have put it like that. Look, here's what I want to say. I believe in marriage. I believe in every marriage. And I think if you just listen to Francis, you'll like what you hear.
Fine.
Francis? I'll just leave you two to talk. You know what? I didn't want to butt in, but I'm glad I did.
What did you do, Lois?
I talked to Piyama. At least she seemed interested in listening to what Francis had to say. He's going to tell her exactly what I told him to say.
What business is it of yours if I don't want to wear thong underpants?
What?
Piyama, I didn't get to finish.
See what happens, Lois.
I don't care what shape we cut the mushrooms. I quit.
This is why you're always going to be a little man living in a little world. I don't need you. I don't need anyone.
You will not be happy.
Boys, this
is the worst Thanksgiving.
Got to do something, Lois. Piyama just asked me for a ride to the bus station.
I thought you didn't want me to interfere.
Okay. I take back everything I said. You can interfere as much as you want. Just fix it.
Well, I'm ready.
Piyama, there's just one thing I want to say. I know that breaking up is painful, but I think in the long run, you'll find it's for the best.
For the best?
Well, Francis, let's be serious. This marriage never had a chance. I just think that you'll be better friends once you're divorced.
Who said we're getting divorced? I love Francis.
You can't stand to see anyone happy, can you, Mom?
Come on, honey. Let's go get my things.
They're out in the trash. Sorry, honey.
That's okay, sweetie. Once again, you've underestimated us. We're not the little dancing monkeys you thought we were.
Thanks, honey.
Right. Look handsome. My little working man's first day on the job. Do not do anything to mess this up. Our whole family needs me to have this job.
Don't worry, Mom. If it'll save the family, I won't stack the toilet paper sideways.
Those kinds of Weisenheimer remarks are exactly what I'm talking about. Now go. You don't want to be late for the training session.
This is ridiculous. You're being completely arbitrary and asinine. One minute you're telling me I'm doing a great job, and the next minute you're writing me up.
You broke the rules, Malcolm.
Come on, that box flattening area is a stupid rule. You know I'm right.
Albert is a grade 5 employee. He has put in 20 years of service time. Sometimes that's more important than what's right or wrong.
Who are you?
Stop being so melodramatic.
No, seriously, I want to know. Because the mother I know has spent her entire life ranting about always doing the right thing, no matter what the cost, no matter how unpopular it is. And now you're standing here getting all caught up in who's a grade 5 and blindly obeying authority.
Honestly, Malcolm, where'd you get the idea that a job is supposed to be fun?
That's not what I'm talking about!
The truth is, work is hard and miserable, and nobody likes doing it.
I have the greatest job in the world!
You got a job?
Yeah, with hygienic meat packing. All I do all day is cut meat with knives and saws. There's blood everywhere, and there's all these guys swearing in Spanish, and they pay me 12 bucks an hour. 12 bucks an hour? I only make 550.
Actually, with the write-up, you're bumped down to 375. Now you better go finish your homework. Dinner's in a half an hour.
Being obsessive about getting written up. So I stayed up all last night thinking up a bunch of comebacks, and I even have potential comebacks to every possible comeback of hers. There's no way she... You're smoking? After all the times you lectured us? After telling us if we smoked, you would kill us before the cancer did? After you would push Francis' lit cigarettes back in his mouth to make him swallow? And you smoke? You smoke?
Look, it's not what you think. When I work, I have 2 cigarettes. One on my morning break, one in the afternoon. No more, no less.
Who are you?
You have to stop saying that. I will quit eventually. But until then, the only thing that's stopping your father from smoking 6 packs a day is knowing that we quit together.
But you didn't quit.
But he knows I did.
But you didn't.
He knows I did.
You lie and you smoke.
Oh, for God's sake, Malcolm.
Lois, I just remembered you were holding my lit cigarette in your hand. And I wanted to thank you for holding onto my cigarettes, which are mine.
He knows.
Okay. I think I left my register open.
Okay, Malcolm, you caught me. This has to be kept secret. So I'm gonna ask you for a favor.
A favor? You're asking me for a favor after you totally hung me out to dry.
I'm just asking for a little flexibility. Please, for your father and for me, just keep the smoking to yourself. Please.
Yeah, okay. Wow, she's talking to me like a human being. This can't get any weirder.
Thank you, Malcolm.
Yes, it can.
Whoa. Malcolm! It's not what it looks like.
Lois, are you in there?
I'll explain later. I know exactly what this looks like to you, but I'm asking you for a little flexibility. Trust me.
Lois, where's the... What's going on here?
Well, I'll have to write Malcolm up again. He's flattened another box outside of the box flattening area.
I can't do any more tonight. Let's just leave the mess and get some sleep, huh?
Wait a minute, we bought 10 presents.
Yeah?
Why are there 11 packages?
Oh my God.
We would have figured it out before we mailed it, right?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
It needs a change.
I want to do it!
No way, we're supposed to take turns.
Mom told us Jamie swallowed one of her diamond earrings. Whoever finds it when it comes out gets a $20 reward.
Let Reese change this one. He hasn't gotten to in a while.
Oh, man.
Somehow they never notice that Mom doesn't own any diamond earrings.
Smells like my ticket to Easy Street.
We got home early. Listen, would it be okay if we walked over and dropped off Jamie for a couple hours? There's a block party here, and we wanted to enjoy it. Okay, great. Thanks.
Enjoy it? Doesn't anyone besides me get it? The whole neighborhood hates us so much that they throw a giant celebration just because we're gone.
Malcolm, that's not news. I'm just surprised they're so organized.
It doesn't bother you that everyone despises us?
No. These people need somebody to be mad at. Having us to hate gives the whole neighborhood something to bond over.
Your mother's right, son. Communities seek out a common enemy. If it wasn't us, they'd all team up against someone else. Probably a minority.
Malcolm, you can't spend your whole life worrying about what people think about you. They'll like you, they'll hate you, they'll think whatever they want to think, and then you die.
Is that supposed to cheer me up?
I don't know why you need cheering up. You are a teenage boy with a block party right outside his door. Now, you can stay in here and sulk if you want to, but your father and I are going to go have a good time.
Come on, honey.
Oh, my God, it's a lawnmower parade.
$3 stuffed animal.
Well, they make those hoops too small on purpose. If I hadn't played till I won, they never would have learned their lesson. Besides, I wasn't trying to win stuffed animal. I was trying to win you.
Oh, hell.
I urge you all to stay calm and try to enjoy the fair anyway. Otherwise, they and their awful children will have won.
Oh, God. They're cheering for my family. I mean, it's for a totally lame and ridiculous reason, but they're cheering.
This is unprecedented. There's only one kielbasa left, and it's on Hell's plate. The title is his, if he can finish it.
Learner's permit. I can drive anywhere with an adult, and the adult does not have to be visible from the outside. I checked.
Everyone taking the test was trying to copy off him.
Wow, Mom's actually proud of me. It's kind of nice to finally have my moment in the...
Dewey, oh my God! Is this what it looks like?
Yes, Mom, this is a friend. His name's Noah.
Oh, Noah, it is such a pleasure to meet you. I can't tell you how thrilled I am.
Mom, if we seem too excited, we're going to spook him. So as far as you're concerned, this is just another day. Come on, Noah.
Dewey! Okay, I'm done now.
Honey, come on out here. I have a surprise for you.
Here. Everybody out. Hal, you're taking the boys to the movies now. Everybody up. Let's go. Let's go.
Well, I didn't know the movie was going to be sold out. I'll get the paper.
I didn't want to see the dog movie anyway.
Well, whatever you say, after you back by 7. Me and Noah are ambushing Kevin Tevens.
Another one? What are you, as enforcer?
It's called being a friend.
Okay, what do you boys want to see?
I don't care. The real fun is being driven there by my dad.
Come on. Hey, what about this one? There's a review right here. Sounds good. Let's go.
have to say, I've only ever seen this on boats. I'm gonna have to make some phone calls on this one.
Go ahead and say it. I know you're dying to.
Why do I always have to be the fun killer?
What are you talking about?
Do you know what it's like to be the person in charge of saying no all the time? I hate it.
Honey, we depend on you for that. You're the one who keeps us from killing ourselves.
Yes, but all I ever hear is, why can't we? And you never let us. Just once. Can't I be the person who gets to have the fun, crazy idea?
You know what? Absolutely. Go ahead. What do you have in mind?
Well, I can't come up with something just on the spot.
Okay. This should stunt the algae growth. This should burn off your outer layer of skin, and these pills will gradually kill what's lodged in your urethra.
It was a kidnapping situation, and it wasn't our fault. Where's Mom and Dad?
They're not home yet.
Oh, my God, this is fate. We said knock, knock, and this is the universe saying, who's there?
If they ask, I was here all night.
Oh, boys. Your mom has a really crazy idea she wants to run by you. Probably too crazy. Lois?
We are going to have ice cream on the good china.
Wow, that's so cool. Okay. Oh,
morning.
What are you hiding?
What are you talking about?
Stop wasting my time. I can smell the guilt from here. You know, if you fess up now, I might go easy on you.
You can't just pretend to know something, hoping I'll blurt out a confession. I'm not hiding anything. Okay, I'm hiding something. Cool, huh? If I hide it from my parents for a month until it heals, then I can take it out and put it back anytime I want. And you know why I did this?
They look so nice together.
Yeah, they do.
I just love weddings.
Where through trust and patience, your love will grow stronger every day. Weren't we supposed to stop this?
I think you're right. I wonder why we didn't.
Who cares? It's nice.
Oh, I'm not worried about it. I'm just happy.
They're all empty. Every bottle.
She drugged us all. That filthy, hateful monster.
But how'd she do it?
The buffet.
Oh, that's right. It showed up right after she went to talk to Mr. Lee.
That evil genius. You know, she knew we couldn't pass up free food.
This is simply the most diabolical, hateful thing she's ever done. But I sure do like her dress. Don't you?
I agree.
It's weird. I used to just think thoughts. I've been scrubbing for an hour. It's not coming off.
Well, since you don't care about your tongue, maybe you could use that to clean the toilet.
I found Grandma's thermos.
Looks like there's still a half cup left of this terrible potion. You know, the lawnmower needs some work. I think I'll go out of the grub. Good, yeah, good idea.
Guess what? I got another raise. Mr. DeSilvio said that when I clean the gunk out of the rendering machine, I vomit less than anyone who's ever worked there.
Well, glad someone's career is on track. My company may not even exist in a month.
Well, what does Nate have to say? He's usually pretty level-headed about this stuff.
Nate faked his death and fled the country.
Didn't he, Jamie? Yes, he did. He did.
Here, do these look like the hands of a lazy man? Do they? Is he how hard the calluses are?
What are you doing here?
This morning, on the phone, you said that I was lazy. Well, look at my hands and admit that you were wrong.
Are you biting your nails again?
Apologize!
I am not going to apologize for something that I said that's true.
This is exactly why I drove 8 straight hours to get here. To prove how far you'll go just to avoid a simple apology. I can't believe how screwed up your priorities are.
Hello?
Oh, hi, baby. Happy anniversary. I gotta figure out whether I'm gonna bat my left-handed speedster at the top of the order or drop him lower so he can hit behind the runners and stay out of the double play.
There. 20 years with the connected out puzzles, model airplanes, and dirty haikus. Do lazy people do this kind of stuff? I don't think so. This proves that you owe me an apology.
Francis, all this proves is that you have a problem with obsessive compulsion.
Lies on top of lies. Well, your house of cards is coming down.
Is he still here? I told Piyama he left this morning.
Hello, Mother.
Hey,
Hey, Francis, I thought you left this morning.
I did. I got halfway home when I suddenly remembered the time when I was 3 years old and you were sick, or so you said, and couldn't drive me to Donnie Dinesco's birthday party. So I rode this tricycle 2 miles in the pouring rain just to get there. Lazy? I think not. Now, I am not leaving until you apologize.
All you want is an apology? That's it? Well, you should have said so a week ago.
But
I'm hereby officially sorry, okay?
No! Not okay! That is not an apology! It's just one of those cleverly designed apologies that sounds like an apology but isn't one. Now you have to apologize for apologizing. And then apologize!
You know what your problem is? You know why you can't accept my apology? Because you just can't stand to be happy.
What?
You have an addiction to trouble. You need to have chaos in your life. You always have. I mean, look at you. You have a great job, a nice home, a wife, and you can't stand it. You have to come back here and pick a fight with your mother.
That's not true. I came back here because you've destroyed any chance any of us ever had for happiness. Tell her, Malcolm. Tell her what a horrible mother she is.
He's right. You insinuate yourself into every part of our lives just to make sure there's no place we're not miserable. Well, you're not going to turn me into a drooling infant like you did Francis.
Yeah.
What? I'm quitting the softball team.
You are doing no such thing, Malcolm. You had a chance to quit, but now we have a game. You made a commitment to a team, and other people are counting on you.
You can't force me to play.
No, but I can confiscate your paychecks.
You're going to take away money that's legally mine for a game of softball?
I don't know. Am I?
You are pure evil.
How do you sleep at night?
Hal, will you please talk to the boys?
Not that, Lois. I have way too much on my mind.
Like what?
I think I'm an international spy, and I don't even know which side I'm on. I could be a supervillain and not even know it.
You can just say you don't want to help me, Hal.
That was a pretty shameful display this afternoon.
Look, I was...
It's all right. I'm not going to ask you why you've been behaving like this lately, because I think I know. You're jealous of the new baby. And you're right. I haven't been giving you enough attention lately. But don't worry. Tomorrow we're going to go out. We're going to get you a haircut and some new undershirts. Just the two of us. Okay?
Thanks, Mom.
She brought the Mustang.
Oh, man. Well, when you hang on to every penny until it screams bloody murder, you can afford nice things. I wish your father and I were better about that instead of frittering our money away on all the little extras for you boys. Susan!
I'm so happy to see you, and I don't want you to worry about your last phone call. I've completely forgiven you.
It's good to see you, too. I guess the drive took a little longer than expected. Well, lunch will taste fine cold.
Hello. Hi, Susan.
Listen to the deep voices. Unbelievable. Lois, they're almost grown, and you're still popping them out. And this must be Jamie.
Hello, sweetie. Hello, cutie pie.
Hi, Susan.
Hal. Look at you. You're such a sweetie pie.
Boys, why don't you go get Aunt Susan's bags out of her fancy car?
That car is outrageous.
Well, sometimes you just have to treat yourself. Oh, and I brought a gift for Jamie.
Whoa, Susan, thank you. After 6 months of shopping, this must be quite a card.
Well, it's not the card. It's what's inside. It's a $5,000 savings bond.
Well, I don't know what to say.
It's going to mature right around the time he's ready to go off to college. Someone should be thinking of that.
Oh, yes, sitting here looking interested finally pays off.
No, Susan, that's not what I meant. I'm uncomfortable with the amount. It's awfully extravagant.
Oh, you think everything's extravagant. Now, I know how much little Dewey likes candy. So I got him a professional cotton candy machine.
Susan, what are you doing? We don't own a circus.
Well, now you can feel like you do. And I'm sorry, but you two boys are going to have to share a gift. I'm giving you the Mustang.
Oh, my God, you're kidding. Thank you. I never believed anything Mom said about you.
Susan, you can't give them a car.
Mom, technically this is a transaction between Aunt Susan and us. And I'm willing to hire a lawyer to enforce it. You want to go there? I'll go there.
You know, Lois, usually when someone gives gifts, people say thank you.
Well, I'm sorry. This sudden generosity coming from you is a little baffling.
Oh, I'm sorry that the concept of opening your heart and giving is so baffling to you.
I don't know. Some people might not think of it as giving. Some people might think of it as just showing off.
Oh, here we go. We're only 3 hours in and we've already received our first visit from the Queen Bee of Moral Superiority.
Oh, and here's the victim right on schedule.
I became the victim on my prom night when I walked into the garage and caught my boyfriend having sex with my sister on the hood of my car.
Where do I look?
There's nowhere to look.
Another exquisite culinary experience, Alfredo.
Ooh.
Doctor's order. Oh, Alfredo, you rake this for me for the tip, please.
Excuse me, what's this SV at the bottom?
That's the service charge.
Service charge? What service charge?
We had 15% for the service. We had a lot of people stiffing the waiters. We've been doing it for years.
Forcing people to tip without telling them? We've been double tipping without realizing it all this time.
There's a notice right here.
That piddly little sign, that's what you use to justify it?
Oh no. Is this going to be shoe store bad or circus bad?
I think it's going to be 10 items or less aisle bad.
Is our car on fire? I think I hear sirens. We better go.
You put up a little sign that nobody can read, and that gives you the right to steal? Where is the manager? I want to see the manager! Don't you give me that look.
I probably won't see you for a while, Manolo. Lo siento mucho.
Yes, it is. Really? Really? Yes! Boys! Boys, it's the owner of Luigi's calling to apologize to your mother. Get your jackets! Boys! The peace of gods have answered our prayers.
Hello?
Hi, this is Lois Gabrisi, the owner of Luigi's. I heard about what happened, and I wanted to call personally to apologize.
Oh, what exactly are you apologizing for?
About the way that you were treated last Thursday. There's no excuse for it, and I couldn't feel more terrible about it.
Well, that's very nice to hear. I am curious why it took 2 weeks to get an apology.
I'm sorry, but you see, I just got in from Europe and I haven't even unpacked yet. The point is that you and your family are valuable customers, and we really want to get you back in here.
Well, I must say, this apology has surpassed my expectations. So, what kind of refund are you giving us?
What?
I figure we overpaid at least $300 over the years. Do you want to send us a check or some kind of gift certificate?
Wait, we can't give you a refund. We don't have those kind of margins.
If you can afford to pay for a trip to Europe, you can afford 1/20th of that to make things right with a customer you cheated.
There is no pizza god.
Well then, I doubt you care, but we are never, ever eating a Luigi's pizza again. At least we have closure.
Hey honey, what are you doing? Are those car keys?
I'm going down to Luigi's.
What? Well, why would you do that?
I'm giving up. I've inflicted this thing on all of you long enough. I'm going to go down there, I'm going to walk up to the counter, and I'm going to do right by my family.
Over my dead body.
What?
You can't give up now. I thought we were a team on this.
Hal, you've all been wonderfully supportive, but maybe enough is enough.
The woman that I love has never thought that enough was enough. The woman that I love is not going to go anywhere near that place in the next hour. We believe in you, Lois. You have got to fight this.
Thank you. You're right. I will.
What is it?
I was ready to give up on my war with Luigi's, and then your father inspired me to take action. So yesterday, I called Clyde on your side.
Who?
You know, that consumer guy on Channel 5. They're doing a whole expose on Luigi's. They told me it was going to be on at 10:23. Oh, whoa. Here it is.
This may look like a friendly neighborhood pizza parlor, but thanks to an alert tipster, we discovered that this hangout could be hanging you out to dry.
Alert tipster, that's me.
It turns out this eatery adds a secret 15% service charge to every tab. I want to be clear, this does not reflect on the Italian people, most of whom are hardworking, decent Americans. But for the cadre of tricksters here at Luigi's, we've got a tip for you. Clean up a you act. Who are the victims in this scam? Senior citizens on a fixed income, local teens after a dance. And of course, the biggest price is paid by the children.
Oh my God!
The fresh-faced youngsters.
That traitor! How could he betray the trust of this family, especially you, Lois?
Doesn't he know what you've been fighting for?
Yeah, that betrayer. Look at him shove that pizza in his mouth right there in the restaurant when we have to sneak ours in the garage.
What?
This isn't just the sad story of one restaurant.
All right. I was saving this until I needed it. Dad, there's a 5-minute imitation of you on the toilet. I'll show you a videotape if you're willing to deal.
You're not gonna do anything? You have to go to that apartment and get him back.
Look, that's not how it works.
Oh, I know how it works. I was thrown into military school so fast I still had shampoo in my hair. The minute a child is inconvenient to you, you kick him out.
Francis, this is really none of your business. You don't even live here anymore.
Because you kicked me out! And now you're doing the same thing to Reese. Right now he's sitting in that apartment with his cable TV and his huge stack of video games. Miserable!
If Reese is unhappy, he brought it on himself.
Really? So what's this, like the 10th time he's brought it on himself? And let's see, Malcolm's brought it on himself 6 times, so with my 28 times, that makes 40 kickouts, 3 different kids, and the only constant through all of this is you two.
Francis, that is not fair.
Maybe you just don't like sharing your house with your children. So when's Dewey gonna bring it on himself? When's Jamie? Where is Jamie?
He's at the babysitter's.
Just till 5.
Our kids would be a mistake.
Hello.
Hello, is this the residence of the most unnurturing, callous parents in the universe?
It's for you.
Hello?
Hi, I just got off the phone with your son, Reese. It's been over a week and you haven't even talked to him? Congratulations, the fracturing of this family is now 2/5 complete.
Francis, this is a very hard and complicated situation and I don't need you to yell at me right now.
There is nothing complicated about it. Just go to his apartment, tell him you love him, and ask him to come home.
Are you nuts? This is Reese we're talking about.
So what?
Come on, you know exactly how he thinks. If we show that kind of weakness, it's like showing a hyena the belly of an antelope. Reese will come home with no limits and no boundaries. Within 5 years, we will be saying our last words to him over a police bullhorn.
All I know is that you have a child that needs you.
No, he doesn't. He's happy where he is, and so are we.
Dewey, get off the phone.
Mom, I understand what you're worried about, but there is more to Reese than you give him credit for.
I wish I could believe that. Honey, I gotta go. There's another call.
Honey.
Hello. Yes, this is she.
This is Peter Noyes, Reese's chemistry teacher. I'm sure you remember me from last year's hearing. There's something new I have to discuss with you.
Oh, my God. What did he do now?
Your son.
He got an A on his midterm?
They matched the handwriting. They had him reenact the experiment. He did it himself. Mr. Noyes said it's the most remarkable turnaround he's ever seen.
Wow.
He also said that we should be really proud of ourselves.
Mom is actually letting me walk all the way to the vending machine and back without tying a string to my waist. Ha! This moment is almost as sweet as a candy you can't have. Wow. Denied candy. If I were 12 years younger, I guess I'd cry.
What's going on out here?
Oh, God, no. The snack bar is closed.
You're denying my son candy?
Mom, it doesn't matter. I'll just go down to the next floor.
You said the vending machine is a privilege, not a right.
If my son wants a candy bar, he can have a candy bar. You don't get to decide for him. I get to decide.
Do I even need to be here for this?
Since I'm the one with the key to the lock, I think I'm in charge.
This isn't over yet.
Mom, why don't you just put me in a diaper?
One thing at a time, Malcolm. First, we're gonna get you that candy.
Well, it's a little early for Christmas carols, isn't it?
Leland, I think we got off on the wrong foot earlier. Obviously, this job is very important to you. Who knows where you could find another that commands respect and power? You know, it'd be such a shame if somehow you got fired and had to go back home where your older brother and sister get all the attention that you deserve. Do you really want to risk that for a 75-cent candy bar?
You really have me pegged. Except for what you're forgetting is, the lower the stakes, the greater the thrill from the arbitrary exercise of power. This was a 1-cent candy bar, I'd be on the moon. I happen to be a control freak. If you get me fired, I'll just find some other job where I can be a control freak. Kinko's is looking for a night manager. Either way, I've already written negative evaluation emails of these kids to the Office of Admissions. All I have to do is hit send.
She overloaded a wall socket too!
We're just like the bulls in Pamplona!
Now you. Any freshman psych major can see it's obvious life didn't pan out the way you thought it would. So now to make up for it, you have to run your kid's life.
I don't know who to root for.
The simple truth is, you're just too afraid to let go of the one thing in your life that may be a success. But hey, you know, you don't have to take my word for it. Why don't we just ask the other mothers here and see what they think? Oh, that's right. There are no other mothers here. You just cost us four of the electricity privileges.
Mom?
I can't do this.
What?
I wanted to help you, to take care of things for you, but you know what? I'm just not up to it. I think you should do this on your own.
What?
It's time for me to step aside and let you handle things. Malcolm, I know you can do this.
Unless I miss a sarcasm, I think she meant that. I've actually been given permission to run my own life. Well, at least get my own candy bar. But you know what? I want that candy bar more than I want my next breath. I have a plan.
Ah! Malcolm, what are you doing?
My plan?
Well, get your foot out of the door!
It's stuck!
By the way, our magical group is having a sing-off against Jazzmatazz tomorrow. You should check it out before you leave.
Oh! When they took the door off the hinges, they discovered Leland had a hot plate. We all got to watch while they made him unplug it and put it in the closet.
Don't worry about it, honey. Just be glad this was our safety school. When we go to Yale, I promise I'll be much more on top of things.
How angry would you be if someone broke your antique music box? Oh, what do you mean? Does it play at all? Great. What? Were you roughhousing in my bedroom? And I don't suppose you're even gonna come out here and face your punishment. Hal, is that you?
Hi, is this where the boy lives who's selling eco bars?
Sorry, we're all out. Come back later.
Well, there you are. We wanted to buy some more of those candy bars that heal the forests. You should be so proud of your boy.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course you do. You said every bar plants a seedling in Fire Rabbit's Yellowstone. Oh, and I love the little bonus of 10% going to pro-life causes.
Wait a minute. He told me 10% went to pro-choice causes.
I didn't know you felt that way.
I didn't know you felt that way.
Excuse me, ladies. I have to tell someone how I feel. You are in so much trouble.
I hope you'll think about what you did every time you see me driving by and your prize.
He's not getting any prize. You've been lying to everyone to get them to buy candy. What do I tell you about lying? Lying is the worst thing you can do. It destroys character, Dewey. It destroys the trust people have in each other. Do you understand?
Yes.
And what do you have to say for yourself?
Francis told me to do it.
I should have known. Did you tell your brother to lie about those candy bars?
You bet I did. And I'm sick of you standing on the sidelines, sabotaging everything we try to do.
Have you lost your mind, Francis? What kind of advice is that to give your brother? This is all your fault.
Where have you been? You've been gone all day. You haven't called. I've been worried sick about you. Well, I have to eat, Lois. I'm a human being.
I'm sorry I'm so late. I had to take the bus home. I sold the car. I bought a plane ticket to Kabul. There's $400 left. I'd give it to you to pay down the visa bill, but I need it for bribes.
What?
I'm gonna go get him.
What are you talking about? You can't just go get him?
Yes, I can. Tonight, I'm gonna buy enough frozen dinners to last you and the boys for 3 weeks. Then tomorrow, I'm flying to Kabul. If I don't get anywhere with the army, I'll hire an interpreter and get the locals to help me. If I have to, I'll make friends with a warlord. Those guys are pretty organized. I'll find him, Hal.
And when does the little bird pop out of your head and start singing?
This is what's happening, Hal.
Lois, you can't do this. At some point, you have to check your ego and leave it to the professionals.
I can't.
Lois, you have this reckless, crazy belief in yourself that lets you do amazing things. It's something this family has always depended on. I would be lost without it, but sometimes that reckless, crazy belief is just reckless and crazy. You've got to accept that some people can do things that you can't. Heart surgeons, rocket scientists, that lady at the mall who carves your name into a grain of rice.
How does she do that?
No one knows. Honey, look. I am giving you permission not to be omnipotent. I know it's gonna be hard, but everything will be okay. I know it will.
Salty or diet?
Mom? Thank you so much. There you are. What in the name of God were you thinking?
Look at you! You are filthy!
Your nails are a disgrace! You've been tomb robbing! Well, the fun stops now, young man! Oh, you are in so much trouble!
Bad. I know. What does he have on you? Oh, man. I have all kinds of things going on he might know about. I have my lost dog scan, the rat baby farm, the electrified mailbox I'm noodling with.
We don't have any choice. We have to neutralize him.
Yeah, but how?
Okay, we let him overhear something we're planning. Something way across town. We make it so juicy and horrible sounding, he won't be able to resist telling Mom. So she waits in the cold for 3 or 4 hours, and when nothing happens, he's lost all his credibility.
Nice.
Ready to go to the sewage treatment plant to do some wanton vandalism?
Yes. I've got the shovels and the flares for the senseless destruction we've got planned. I sure hope Mom doesn't ever find out.
Don't worry about Mom. She's too stupid. And besides, she's probably busy stuffing her fat face.
I sure hope Mom doesn't ever find out you said that. By the way, do you think she's gotten stupider or fatter?
Good question. I'd say...
All right, honey, I'm going to the park. Oh, I hate ab days. They keep pulling me in to judge. All I know is somebody's tummy is not going to be as flat as somebody else's, and somebody's going to end up crying.
Look at this, Hal. They still haven't found those kids.
I'm kidding.
This is terrible. Where could they be? All those kids are such messes. They don't know how to take care of themselves. Someone has to help them.
Someone will help them.
Excuse me. I know you didn't think anyone would catch you, but you just slammed your door into my car. The least you can do is say you're sorry, lady.
You don't have to take that tone. It's not like I'm hurting your resale value.
I'm sorry. See? Like that. Lost control of myself. It was like an out-of-body experience, and I was there watching this woman go insane, and the woman was me. But you know what, Hal? I'd do it all over again. It felt great.
It was almost worth destroying my car.
Well, honey, the important thing is no cops were there to see it.
No one says a word. This is my one to your 11,000. So, due to unforeseen circumstances, we are now completely broke. Therefore, I am making a proclamation. This will be a handmade Christmas. We're not spending any money on gifts. They will be homemade, and therefore more personal and more thoughtful.
But you can't do this!
Well, I think it's high time we had a handmade Christmas. You boys just don't appreciate the holidays. To you, it's nothing but a disgusting orgy of materialism.
But
no buts! You're the ones who turned your mother into a ticking time bomb. Oh, you just thank your lucky stars that she went off on an innocent bystander.
So we had our Christmas feast of oatmeal and hot dog buns. Since then, we've been waiting 3 hours for Dad to come out of the garage.
What is... Oh my God!
Did you hear something?
What are you boys doing up there?
It's Mom. How'd she know where to find us?
I told you she's got tracking devices in our fillings. If you two geniuses had ripped them out like I did, we wouldn't be in this mess.
Maybe she didn't see us.
Reese, Malcolm, Dewey, you get down here this instant!
Mrs., I don't know who you are thinking we are. Your boys are very different boys than we are being.
Oh, no.
Where's the back door in this thing? It's a billboard.
We are so dead. This time she'll finish us. What are we gonna do?
Oh, God. Why do billboards have to be so visible?
Calm down now.
Reese, give me your pocket knife.
But if you miss her, you'll only make her madder.
What are you doing?
Hold on. I know that look. He's using his brain.
We can't come down because we are protesting this offensive depiction of women.
What?
What?
We've come up here to make a difference in the world.
Yeah!
To speak for women like this one who can't speak for themselves.
Yeah! Because they're billboards.
Shut up. We're not coming down until women everywhere get the respect they deserve. No matter how long it takes, we're staying up here.
Oh, for the love of God, I don't know who you think you're fooling.
It's about time!
Thank you, boys!
God bless you!
Sit still or I can't get the bandage on.
Just keep your eyes on the stump, Romeo.
Well, okay. I put all the doctor's numbers on the fridge. Safety rail is up in the shower. Thank you, Francis. I have to tell you something.
What?
I wasn't a good enough mother to you, and I'm sorry. I shouldn't have left you with her, and I shouldn't have sent you to military school. I got overwhelmed, and I took things out in you that weren't your fault. They were my fault, and I'm sorry.
But...
But nothing. I like to think I was a little bit better with the other boys, but that's just further proof that you got a terrible deal.
Yes. Boo-hoo for the boy with two legs.
You deserved a mother who was more patient and more caring. And it breaks my heart that you didn't get that mother.
Thank you. Wow. 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 I've just waited so many years to hear you say that. Why don't I feel better?
What do you mean?
I mean, I actually had fantasies where you said that pretty much word for word. It's spooky how close it is, but it's not helping. Why didn't it help?
You want me to say something else?
No, I mean, you said everything. Anything else would just be fake. I mean, that was like the perfect thing, and I'm still filled with all this resentment. Oh my God, this sucks! That was like the one thing that I was living for, and it's just not working at all!
Can you take the soap opera outside? I want to watch the whore that gives the weather.
Mother, please! Honey, just try to breathe!
No, you can't just have your life dreams stripped away from you and be okay about it!
Do you want a cold washcloth?
I don't think so. I don't know. I don't know what I want.
Do you want me to give you some money?
How much money?
I have $200. I only need 30 for the bus.
Okay.
Here.
And the Tic Tacs.
Okay.
Honey, just remember that I love you. In my own imperfect, bad mothering way, I do love you.
I love you too.
Okay. I'll call you.
Okay, Rockefeller, it's lotion time. Cut your nails.
Guess who's getting a treat? That's right, it's you, Mr. Boy.
In this house, whenever anybody is good for 3 whole days in a row, they get one of Mama's extra special fruit smoothies. I have never made one before. Ah, this is outrageous!
What's the matter?
The blender is broken. There's no excuse for this.
Well, honey, we have had it since before Dewey was born.
I don't care. They said a lifetime guarantee. A lifetime is not 10 or 11 years. Hell, if they want to say a 10 or 11 year guarantee, that's fine. I'll make my blender buying decisions accordingly, but they said lifetime. I'm getting my money back. Or a blender of equal or greater value.
Well, how are you going to find the warranty from 10 years ago?
I'm sure it's with the rest of the papers in the garage.
Oh, honey, you'll never find it out there. I mean, what did this cost? $19?
That's what they want you to say. That's why they don't charge more. That's how they get you. Blender companies don't think we're smart enough to save warranties. They think we run around barefoot all day picking bugs off ourselves. Well, they are in for a big surprise. They design their products specifically to break down 3 days after the warranties get lost. It's called planned obsolescence. Like that death trap of a high chair you keep falling over in. I'm their worst nightmare, Jamie. A woman who saves everything. And I'm gonna go through every shred of it. What's that, Mr. Big Blender Company man? You say I'm gonna need paperwork? Oh, gee, I don't know if I have it. Oh, wait, I do.
I have something to tell you.
Hal, it'll have to wait. I wasted a half an hour getting Jamie to sleep. He kept crying because I wouldn't let him have the antifreeze bottle in bed with him.
Lois, this is important. I was trying to spare you the embarrassment, but you should probably know. Dewey actually asked me first about the sleepover, and he went to you when I said no.
Oh, sorry.
What do you mean, sorry? Maybe you don't understand. He went around my back to get to you.
And this is a big upset for you? For God's sake, Hal, they go behind my back to get to you all the time.
That is very different. You are the hard ass. I'm the nice, fair one. Dewey knows that. Why would he betray me?
Hal, I cannot get worked up about this right now. I have to find that warranty or the blender company wins. Is that what you want, Hal? Are you on their side?
Fine, I'll help you.
No, Hal, I have a system. Anyway, it seems to be going fine. I haven't heard a peep out of him in hours. Hal, what are you doing?
Just trying to think of some wise things to say to Francis tomorrow. The father should have some wisdom for his son, don't you think?
Well, it is a big day. You only turn 21 once.
Hey, remember before he was born and I had that Harley day?
No motorcycles ever! You do not talk about motorcycles. You do not think, you do not wish, you do not even reminisce about those stupid, idiotic death traps. They do not exist. Motorcycles do not exist. Say it.
Motorcycles do not exist.
What does not exist?
I don't know.
Good. I finished. I almost gave up and I thought I burned the prunes, but then I fell into this rhythm and just lost track of time. Next thing you know, it's done. And it came out perfect. It was a lot of work. But you know something? It feels good. What's that?
That's the real dog.
You kept screwing up. We just knew it would be easier for everyone if we just made it ourselves.
But I worked for days.
Oh, sorry. I know you'd rather be at the disco, shaking your backside at a bunch of drug addicts.
Yeah. Oh, you like St. Grotus Day? Huh? You like tarts? Well, what are we waiting for? Let's celebrate! Well,
Maybe next time you'll think better before criticizing other people's desserts.
This makes up for everything.
Is Doug supposed to impress me?
Mother, I swear to God, I almost quit twice between the first and the second corset. I am this close.
All right. You want to dance? We dance.
What are you doing?
I'm not dancing in this thing. This gets in the way. Begin we now, devotion is sabor. The dance where mistakes are long remembered.
To remind the little man who's boss. They're just trying to motivate me to keep me in my place, to kill any dreams I might have of ever digging my way out. Oh, my God. It starts at 9?
Sorry, I forgot how late it was.
Why are your fingernails clean? Did you clean your fingernails?
Thought I'd try it, and turns out I like it. Makes me feel good about myself.
Well, that's enough of that. It's time for dinner.
I missed lunch. I was at the library, and I forgot to look at the clock.
Do you think I'm an idiot?
Huh?
Do you think I don't know where you've been?
What do you mean?
You think I wouldn't recognize the signs? Clean fingernails, good posture, cookie crumbs in your pockets. You're never hungry at dinner time. You're seeing another mom.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't lie to me!
It's not what you think.
Who is she?
Why does that matter?
Who is she?
Mrs. Finnegan. It doesn't mean anything. A couple weeks ago, I stopped by her house and she had her iron out. She was just so nice. And there was cake!
That'll be a long time before you get any cake around here.
I wasn't expecting any.
After everything I've sacrificed for you, all I've done, you come waltzing in here day after day reeking of her fabric softener.
Yes! I like fabric softener. Mrs. Finnegan doesn't mind taking a little time to stop the rinse cycle. And maybe it's nice to have someone who's got more to say to me than just clean your room, comb your hair, da-da-da-da-da.
Do you love her?
Of course not. It's just snacks.
Oh, you like her snacks. You like filling up on her cookies. You know they're store-bought.
That's beneath you, Mom. Hey, Mom.
Here's your lunch.
Meatloaf sandwich.
Oh, morning, dear. Mwah. Oh, honey, it feels so good to be helping people take control of their lives.
Milton, in accounting, called me from the Motel 6 this morning. He had to leave his wife and kids, but as soon as the Ice Capades reads his script, he's moving the whole family to New York. What are you doing?
Oh, I keep trying and trying to get Jamie to use the potty, but he keeps refusing. Those stupid parenting books say to put stickers all over it and make it a happy place, so I figured why not. I obviously don't know anything about raising children. Damn it. What's wrong with these boys?
Honey, let me handle this.
You are a superstar. You're not afraid of this potty. This potty is afraid of you. You have to visualize your success. Now, let's look at the 5 lies you tell yourself that prevent you from being all that you can be.
Oh, hell.
Mom?
Dewey?
I want to talk.
I really don't feel up to that right now.
I know I hurt you, and I'm very sorry.
Thank you, Dewey.
But words are cheap. I wanted to do something that would show you I'm committed to this relationship. I want you to know how much you mean to me. I want you to know that no one can take your place. I'm going back Tuesday. I passed out before they colored in the drop shadow.
It's not that I don't appreciate you. We are going down to the hospital and you're gonna have that lasered off right the... Okay. I know you're trying to... But what is wrong with... Malcolm, come on, we're gonna be late!
All right, I'm coming!
Why aren't you wearing your smock?
Because the longer I don't put it on, the longer I can pretend I don't work in that soul-killing fluorescent tomb. As shocking as it may sound to you, I don't actually like stocking wart cream and telling 8-year-olds which diapers leak the least.
Thank you, Mother, for getting me a job so I don't have to be a bum on the street. You're welcome. Can I open the door for you after everything you've sacrificed for me? Why, that's very thoughtful of you. You really gotta stop being such a snob. There's pride in doing anything well. I'd rather you were the best toilet scrubber in the world than a slapdash Supreme Court justice. And how about showing a little gratitude? There's nothing embarrassing about working at Lucky Aid.
Listen to your mother.
Is everything all right?
Not yet, but it will be. As soon as you put these on.
Are you crazy?
Loving your wife is crazy? Then I'm a drooling lunatic. You deserve the moon and the sky, Lois. Maybe someday I'll be able to buy them for you, but for now, these will have to do.
Oh, Al. Thank you!
I accidentally spent $800 on phone sex.
I was doing my makeup in the rearview mirror and I ran over your golf clubs.
I burned a hole in your favorite dress.
You didn't get that promotion because I called your boss a fat ass at the Christmas party.
I lost my wedding ring 3 years ago. This is part of a lawnmower.
Your Aunt Lucy isn't angry with you. She's dead. I just forgot to tell you.
Purposely dropped that bowling ball on your foot so you couldn't go to your high school reunion.
I'm 2 years older than you think I am. Damn it, Hal. We're reaching a point here I don't think either one of us wants to get to.
What are we supposed to do? I've just got so much rage built up.
Are these your boys?
You little monsters. How dare you get into trouble again after all your mother does for you?
Your father slaves away to put a roof over your head, and this is how you repay him?
Okay, everybody, let's just calm down.
Why don't you mind your own business? We don't need you coming in here and telling us how to handle our children. We know what we're doing. Thank you very much.
Oh, Dad, the drugs are wearing off.
Sundance, baby, is that you?
Good morning, Reese. You gonna get a job today?
Okay, this is a little freaky.
I don't see you looking in the want ads.
You know, I had a job, Mom. And looking back on the whole experience, I've come to the conclusion that it's just not for me. I'm done with the job thing.
I'm sorry, Reese, but not working isn't one of your options.
Okay, I think I know what's going on here. Now look, I want you to know that I'm not criticizing you and Dad. You obviously don't mind wasting your lives doing meaningless, repetitive tasks for unappreciative bosses. I respect that.
Do you mind telling me what you intend to do?
I'd like to finish my cereal.
All right, Reese, that's it! I am tired of fighting you on this. Until you get a job, this free ride is over.
Is anyone else getting a little tired of her? Sorry, Spider-Man. Oh, That breakfast looks pretty good.
Yeah, it is. You want to do me a favor and go stink it up someplace else?
How do you think I feel? I have to smell me all the time. Look, I've been having a tough week. Is there any chance you could lend me a couple bucks?
Ooh, sorry, I don't have my wallet on me. I'll catch you next time.
God bless you.
You know, Dewey, what Reese is doing is pointless and idiotic, but I think you can really learn something from him. This is what it looks like when someone stands up for themselves.
I didn't get the free game, Dad. I accept that we don't always get what we want. Being part of this family's really prepared me for that.
Listen, do me a favor, will you? Talk to your brother.
I'll see what I can do. Do you think he'd help a guy a little down on his luck?
Here, don't tell your mother.
Smells like a dead squirrel's in the wall again, Hal. Oh, my God, it's you, Reese. You smell like an open sewer.
And whose fault is that?
Yours. All you have to do to stop this nonsense is get a job.
Excuse me, but I think I've made it pretty clear where I stand on that issue.
Well, you can't stay here like this.
Is that an apology?
No, it's an invitation to live in the backyard.
Listen to yourself. You don't even sound the least bit guilty.
I've given you enough chances. Out!
Okay, but if the cats start disappearing from the neighborhood, don't blame me.
Oh, no, you don't! Reese!
Okay, what now?
What on earth do you think you're doing?
We're testing out our new heating system. I think it's gonna be a very comfortable winter.
Hi, Lloyd Johnson. I'm an associate of your son's.
Get out of here before I turn the hose on you! You can't treat Lloyd like that with the CIA did to his brainwaves.
Reese, I want you to get this eyesore out of here right now!
Eyesore? That is a Sub-Zero box. It's a hell of a lot nicer than anything we've ever thrown out.
All right, you won't get rid of it? I will!
I could have told you those boxes are reinforced. With some curtains and a couple of plants, it was going to look very nice.
Oh, just shut up and help me get in the house! Oh!
Hey, the heating pad's plugged in. Here's your aspirin. And let me know if you need anything else. I'm really sorry about your back, Mom.
Thank you, Reese. I'm still angry with you. But you've really come through for me. Your blankets and your sheets are in the trunk of my car. You can move back in if you want.
Thanks, Mom. I'd like that.
Our credit card company sent us a collection notice and an application for a new card. Oh, my God.
What is it?
It's a check from Malcolm for ten...
Yes. Hello, Governor. Is your mum at home?
It's Dad.
Hal?
Clothesline.
What's he doing here?
He's in.
What? How did
he... He just is! Look, it isn't important how it happened. Let's just move on with this, okay?
Look, Dewey, you understand we're not stealing this money. Every cent is going back to Malcolm. We're a bank.
Yeah, well, this bank's getting a Rolex. A big one.
That money's going towards new pipes for the house.
She can spend her share any way she wants.
And I'm spending my share on a Rolex. I think I've earned it.
There are no shares. Listen to me. We are not splitting up that money.
Who put you in charge?
Yeah, who put you in charge? Let's vote.
There will be no voting.
I vote there's voting.
Me too. I'm going to get the money.
It's not there anymore. I moved it.
I know. I moved it from where you moved.
And I moved it again.
What?
You did.
I was the one who came up with this idea.
The money's safe.
Give it. Here, let go. I want the... And that is the French tuck.
Where have you been?
Cool.
That story better hold up, mister.
Your father wants to count the money again.
I just think we all get along better when we know it's all here. By the way, I'm gonna need some of this. Got an estimate to fix my transmission.
This receipt is from 1986, Hal. I can see where you erased the date.
Amateur.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do I know this plumber's for real and not just some actor that you hired?
Yeah. I held auditions while you were at work, Hal.
I knew it!
Listen to yourself. You've gone insane.
That would be pretty convenient for you, wouldn't it? Well, you are not locking me away.
I haven't trusted either of you since I was six.
All right. Let's just split it. Three ways and we'll all be happy.
I wouldn't say happy, but it's a start.
I have a better idea. We just stop this nonsense and give the money back to Malcolm.
Okay, you can have your pipes.
No, Hal, this isn't a bargaining tool. This money has turned us into animals. I'm going down to the bank tomorrow morning and getting a cashier's check in Malcolm's name. Then the three of us can slink away and forget that this whole thing ever happened.
Can't you control that woman?
Watch your tone, young man.
Or else what? You'll just cave like you did with Mom.
All right, that's it. Go to your room.
I think maybe we should both go to our rooms.
Fine!
Yeah, you were right. We're turning into monsters. The bad kind.
You're just so much stronger than we are. Thank God for your level-headedness. Thank God there was someone in this house who was able to keep their sanity. And you taught us a lot of important lessons about honesty and trust. So, if you'll just tell us where you hid the money.
I've done something very bad.
What?
There was this antique store across the street from the bank, and I saw this dollhouse in the window. And the next thing I knew, I was walking out with it. It was like that money in my pocket killed the old Lois and replaced it with a crazy person.
That's okay, honey. I mean, so what if you spent a couple hundred dollars on a dollhouse? It's no big deal. Now, where's the rest of the money?
There isn't any.
What?
You spent $10,000 on a stupid dollhouse?
They wanted 12. But look, Hal, there's the tiny little dumbwaiter and the lights really work.
No! Okay, I sold my car.
Well, we'll add that to what I got for my engagement ring and my grandmother's pearls.
No one wanted to buy my bike, but a bunch of kids did pay to watch me eat a centipede.
We're doing the right thing. We should all remember that.
Quit sermonizing. I'll get enough of that from the nut jobs on the bus.
You guys aren't gonna believe it. I got a McClellan Fellowship grant for $3,857.
That's wonderful, Malcolm.
Congratulations, son.
Yeah, congratulations.
This couldn't have come at a better time. I know exactly what I'm gonna do with it.
Ma'am, we need to get back in line.
Oh, we're just trying to get in the empty one.
That line is for first class and Commodore's Club passengers only.
Excuse me?
We need to make this flight.
So this airport's policy is that increased security should only inconvenience poor people.
I don't make the rules, ma'am.
No, no one makes the rules. Why would anyone want to take responsibility?
Mom!
Ma'am, step over here, please.
Oh, I know what it is. It's this underwire in my bra. It always sets these things off.
You seem to have something under your shirt.
Yes, as I said, I have a bra on under my shirt, and there is an underwire in my bra.
Code 25.
I can't believe this is the first underwire to come through this place. Surely you people have encountered bras before. This is punishment for what I said about the first class line, isn't it?
Ma'am, I need to touch your breasts.
You need to touch my what?
I'm required to probe with the back of my hand. If you like, you can request up to 2 female witnesses.
Let me understand this. Because I made a comment about first class, I am being singled out for a public feel-up?
Now, do you want to do this the easy way or the hard way? Okay, the tickets are changed. The next flight leaves in 15 hours.
So I get no time to practice and no sleep tonight.
You should have seen what happened the first time I touched them. Here's our heart.
Stop me!
Crush my fingers!
Oh, I didn't mean to. Let me see.
What you did to me?
Keep the fingers elevated, Dewey, and don't worry. I know where I can find some Evian ice.
Hey, honey.
What have you been doing?
Well, I can honestly say I have no idea. Do you want me to...
No. Stupid hot sauce.
You okay?
Dewey's been absolutely horrible to me. I know we missed the flight. I know I hurt his fingers. I know this isn't the greatest day of his life, but he's been acting like I'm trying to ruin his contest on purpose.
Well, honey, it has been an awful lot of stuff in a row.
What are you saying, Hal? You agree with him? You actually think that I was... Oh!
Well, apparently only permanent blindness gets you bumped up to first class.
Well, the redness is going down. I think you can compete just fine.
Why don't you just cut the act, Mom? You got what you wanted.
What are you talking about?
You don't like watching me be successful because it reminds you that you never did anything with your life. And now, instead of taking joy in your kids' accomplishments, you undermine us so we won't show you up. Maybe it's unconscious, maybe you know you're doing it. But that's what's been going on this whole trip.
So what?
Huh?
You think you're the first kid in the world whose parents ever sabotaged him? Please, Dewey, parents undermine their children all the time.
My dad told me I would never amount to anything and live a life of hardship and constant disappointment.
Wait, we're talking about Mom.
Well, you shouldn't be. This is your life. Crap flies at you. You gotta learn to deal with it. Besides, which story would you rather tell? The one where you show up at a contest, play something, and get a prize? Or the one where your family torpedoes you, and even though you are crippled and blind, you still come through to win first place?
Guess the second one's a better story.
Of course it is.
Okay, Mom. Let's go to St. Louis.
Damn straight. Let's win this thing. Oh, Reese, don't be silly. These tests are for people who aren't living together, who aren't in love. You have a real marriage. This is no problem.
But, Mom, what if I...
You'll be fine. This is a mother's promise to her son. Oh, wow, Reese, I'm so, so sorry.
Quit stalling. How'd I do?
The INS is denying Raduca's request for a green card. They're questioning the validity of your marriage. They want her to report to their office tomorrow. You said Raduca had a tail?
Might have a tail. I don't know what the hell is going on back there. I was nervous.
Reese, I feel just terrible.
That's it. It's the end of my marriage. The one thing that was going right in my life is ruined.
No, Reese, nothing is ruined. If you love this girl, you'll find a way to overcome this obstacle.
I don't know.
Remember when I told you you couldn't keep that tarantula? 6 months later, what did I find in my salad?
My tarantula?
You hung on to it because you loved it. And you love Raduca. We are not going to let the United States government smash her with a shoe. Come on, let's go tell her we'll figure out a way to work this thing out.
Oh my God!
How come your brother doesn't have a waiting period?
Dewey, I just got off the phone with your English teacher. She said you got an F on your paper.
Huh?
An F! You keep this up, you'll fail the class, which will go on your record, which will determine where you are placed in high school and where you will go to college, if anywhere.
Don't go to college. It's okay with me.
How do you think you're going to make your way in the world?
You don't get it, Mom. Things take care of themselves.
Rock on.
We've all come a long way, but we still have a long way to go. None of us could have gotten to where we are today if it wasn't for everyone here. But there is one man that I would especially like to thank, Francis! Francis, your honesty has really helped me through this. I went through life feeling pretty sorry for myself, thinking that I was brutalized and abused. But then I heard your horror stories, and I realized that my junky, abusive mom wasn't that bad at all. Oh, sure, she beat me. She left me in that dumpster and all, but she was a saint compared to Elle. I don't know how you survived her, man, but I thank God you did.
Elle? Elle, can you believe this?
Oh, they're so open here. It's just so raw. It's beautiful.
Let's be fair. We all have an Elle in our lives. My Elle was the Vietnam War. Thankfully, though, I don't have to visit my Elle on Christmas and holidays. I can leave my Elle buried deep in the darkest recesses of my mind. And I thank God for that. Stay strong, Francis.
And now, let's hear from the man of the hour, our very own Francis.
Thanks, George. Thank you all. A lot of horrible things have been said tonight, and I appreciate your honesty. But that's in the past. We need to clean the slate and start over, and to do that, we need to make amends to the people we have wronged. To my beautiful wife, Piyama, for all the terrible things I put you through. I'm sorry. And to my brothers, who aren't here right now, for all the times I couldn't be there for you because I was in my own messed up place. I'm sorry. To my father. I put you through so much, yet you were always there for me. I'm sorry. And to my mother. Al, I forgive you.
Forgive me? For a celebration, and instead you blindside me? You told complete strangers that I'm a monster!
Mom, I acknowledge your anger.
Well, get ready to acknowledge a lot more! Oh, you forgive me, Francis. Do you forgive me for 27 hours of labor? For staying up all night with you when you were sick with a 105-degree temperature? For the thousands of hours I spent trying to get you to do your homework!
Yes, Mom. I forgive you.
So it's all my fault that your life is messed up and you're an alcoholic. I'm the source of everything wrong with your life.
Mom, I'd love to get into this, but we don't talk about these things outside the meeting.
Well, get in the car. We're going back.
Lois, let's not ruin Francis's special day.
Why not? Apparently I've ruined everything else.
What's past is past.
What's past is past? So you think this is all my fault too?
Can we discuss this in the other room?
There is no other room! Side in this?
I'm not taking anyone's side. There are no sides. I'm just saying, look at it from Francis's side.
He crucified me in that meeting.
You're right to feel attacked by these people, but this is about Francis. He's building a new life. We've got to go easy on him. He's only been sober for 1 year. He's a one-year-old. You're fighting with an infant.
That infant dragged my name through the mud and now wants us to give him $20,000.
This is an investment in a business for our son.
But he quit drinking and now magically he knows how to run a business?
See, you are still stuck in this stupid death struggle that you have had with him since he was born. Francis has changed, and you have got to face that fact.
No, Francis has not changed. He has just changed his tricks to get what he wants. This whole day has been about getting us to sign that loan.
There you go again. I know for a fact this is not about the loan.
How do you know that?
Because I've already signed it, okay? So can we just move on?
What?
On this. You think you're going to get away with this? You are sadly mistaken. $20,000, Francis? How in the world would you... What's this?
The loan. If you're not on board, we won't do it.
What?
I don't want you and Dad fighting because of us. This is not how we wanted to start our business. Piam and I will just get the money from someone else.
But I was... Really?
Reese, I just bought that for you. Will you look at... Give it to me. Let me see what I can do with it.
I sneezed in ChemLab and spilled acid on it.
I'm not wearing these stupid shorts anymore. Everyone's making fun of me.
A denim tie. How cool is that?
Nod when you see one. Krista, it's okay. She can't hurt you now.
I just love that beautiful hair. Don't you, sweetie?
Hi, Al. Come out of school.
Okay, I guess. Well, there was this one weird thing. This girl named Kristen. She's one of the girls that picked on Reese. You're not gonna believe what happened to her. They tried to get it all out, but I heard the janitor ended up having to cut off all her hair with a hedge trimmer.
Really? That's terrible. People can be so cruel.
Oh, absolutely. Ugh, I know, exactly. Now, Kristen could not stop sobbing. I'm IMing her right now, she's a complete wreck. I know, did you see her without her hair? You know, I never realized she had such a tiny head. Oh, but you know what the best part is? Now Dylan's available. Does he? No, get out! Who did this? Moppet? Baby? No!
It's you! There you are. You took off so fast from school, we didn't get a chance to talk about what happened to Diane.
I'm a very busy woman, Malcolm. It isn't easy running this household.
I can imagine. Cooking, shopping, cutting the heads off of dolls.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Come on, Mom. It's pretty obvious what's going on here, and I think it's sick. Did you see Diane's reaction?
No, I didn't. Was she crying?
She'd be wrapped in a blanket and carried to the school nurse's office.
Terrible. Just terrible. There's a salad in the fridge, and you boys can make yourself sloppy joes whenever you're hungry. I've got some errands to run.
Oh, errands, right? I know what you're up to, Mom.
Oh, yes, Malcolm, you've caught me. I've got to return an overdue video, go to the cleaners, and pick up milk and cereal for the morning. Guilty as charged.
Oh, nice try. Now, I want you to look me in the eye and... Mom, I know you're behind all this, and sooner or later, you're gonna have to talk to me.
Oh, for God's sake, Malcolm, can't I have a moment's rest?
No, you can't. Tell me, did it feel good to cut through Elmo's neck? Did it? Mom? Mom?
I have to humor him until he reveals himself. This has gotta be the place. There you are! You are in so much trouble, young man!
I want my wallet now.
Hey,
At least we got here before you spent all my cash.
It costs so much to keep this place open after hours. I had to put that on your credit card.
Okay, Mr. Smart Guy. Now you can help us load all this stuff back in the car. I know you think you're having a party, but you can forget about it.
Oh. This isn't for me. It's too late for my childhood. But it's not too late for his.
Jamie?
Here's a camera. So now you have no excuse for not documenting every important event in Jamie's life. Starting tonight with his party.
That is a really nice camera. How could you afford... Right.
Let's go have some cake. That was a good thing you did, son.
Thanks.
Enjoy the cake. That's the last thing you're gonna eat in a long time that hasn't been dipped in sardine juice. Hey, finally, a picture for your memory book.
We might as well go ahead and have kids. I'm not afraid of changing diapers anymore.
Good job, Reese.
Hey, I am the victim here. Those are my hopes and dreams you're scrubbing out of your cracks.
Anybody else hungry?
Oh, Mother!
You know what? I'm glad. This is appropriate. Now my life looks exactly how I feel. How could you screw me over like that?
Because you were going to take that job, and we are not going to let you throw your life away.
How is being rich throwing my life away?
Because it's not the life you're supposed to have. The life you're supposed to have is you go to Harvard, and you earn every fellowship and internship they have. You graduate first in your class and you start working in public service, either district attorney or running some foundation, and then you become governor of a mid-sized state, and then you become president.
What?
Of the United States.
Dad.
I'm sorry, son. It's true.
Thought you knew.
Our expectations started out much smaller, but you just kept upping the ante.
What if I don't want to be president?
It's too late for that. You're going to do it.
Oh, really? Have you decided my position on capital gains tax cuts? What are my foreign policy objectives?
That doesn't matter. What does matter is you'll be the only person in that position who will ever give a crap about people like us. We've been getting the short end of the stick for thousands of years, and I, for one, am sick of it. Now you are going to be president, mister, and that's the end of it.
Did it ever occur to you that I could have taken this job, gotten really rich, and then bought my way into being president?
Of course it did. We decided against it.
What?
Because then you wouldn't be a good president. You wouldn't have suffered enough.
I've been suffering all my life.
I'm sorry. It's not enough. You know what it's like to be poor, and you know what it's like to work hard. Now you're going to learn what it's like to sweep floors and bust your ass and accomplish twice as much as all the kids around you. And it won't mean anything because they will still look down on you. And you will want so much for them to like you, and they just won't. And it'll break your heart. And that'll make your heart bigger and open your eyes, and finally you will realize that there's more to life than proving you're the smartest person in the world. I'm sorry, Malcolm, but you don't get the easy path. You don't get to just have fun and be rich and live the life of luxury.
That's Dewey.
Really?
This is unbelievable. You actually expect me to be president. No, I'm sorry. You expect me to be one of the greatest presidents in the history of the United States.
You look me in the eye and you tell me you can't do it.